अमृता पूजा मैम, आर यू देयर?
यस मा,
या प्लीज
शैल आई
स्टार्ट.
स्टार्ट मा?
या प्लीज.
गुड आफ्टरनून वन एंड ऑल. वंस अगेन आई अपोलोजाइज एवरीबॉडी फॉर द इनकन्वीनियंस. आई पूजा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स, टेक दिस प्लेजर टू वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर टुडेज एफडीपी, इंफॉर्मेशन न्यूज एंड लिटरेसी इनिशिएटिव, ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय शेषाद्रिपुरम डिग्री कॉलेज in association with Seshadripuram Institute of Commerce and Management, Bangalore, and Seshadripuram Independent Pre-University College, Mysuru. Firstly, I would like to welcome all the office bearers and trustees of Seshadripuram Education Trust, Bangalore. A happy welcome to you all. I welcome resource person of today's FDP, Dr. Sapna, Professor, Department of Journalism, University of Mysuru. She has 17 years of experience in media education, along with the specialization in corporate communication and electronic media. Dr. Sapna is a regular visiting faculty to various educational institutions such as Karnataka Police Academy, Administrative Training Institute, HRDC of various universities. Recently, she has written a book titled Corporate Communication for the benefit of journalism and management students. Presently, she is also the coordinator of Radio Manasa, community radio station of University of Mysuru. Dr. Sapna is an avid traveler and has visited various countries like Brazil, Maldives, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Philippines, Dubai for conducting various academic activities. She has presented papers in and around 70 international and national mass media conferences and have also published over 40 papers in various media journals on different topics related to media and mass communication. She has been a gold medalist and a rank holder from the university and has been awarded the Best Media Educator Award in 2018. By Exchange for Media, New Delhi. Dr. Sapna had completed project from UNICEF on development reporting on adolescence and has been a freelance journalist and has contributed to Times of India, Indian Express on various issues. Dr. Sapna MS has also received an Indo-Sri Lankan fellowship in the year 2019 to visit Colombo for upgrading the syllabus pertaining to media education in Sri Lanka. Dr. Sapna has produced 10 PhD candidates, and presently 8 candidates are pursuing their research under her. So it's a honor to have such an eminent speaker for today's FDP. I extend a warm welcome to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Putin.
I also welcome Professor Vidya Shivanava, Principal, Sheshadripuram Institute of Commerce and Management, Bangalore. A hearty welcome to you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
I welcome Professor Archana Swami N, Principal, Sheshadripuram Independent PU College, Mysuru. A glad welcome to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Pooja.
I also welcome Professor Soumya Irappake, Principal, Sheshadripuram Degree College, Mysuru. A genial welcome to you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
I extend a pleasant welcome to all the teaching and non-teaching staff of Sheshadripuram Degree College, Mysuru, Sheshadripuram Institute of Commerce and Management, Bangalore, and Sheshadripuram Independent Pre-University College, Mysuru. I welcome one and all. Now I request Dr. Sapna MS to take over the session.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for the sweet introduction. First and foremost, I would like to apologize for making you all wait, and we are already delayed by 1 hour and extremely sorry about it. It was mainly because of the technical slug at my internet thing, so I was not able to reconnect. There was some problem, and I requested Professor Soumya Irappa, who was very good enough to accept my requisition of conducting this FDP program in the initial thing. And she also asked me, when I requested her that whether if I can postpone the thing for 1 hour, because I know time is very precious for everybody and you'll be having your own commitments and all, and extremely sorry about it. But anyways, with further delay and all, first and foremost, I'd like to thank the Sheshadripuram Degree College Mysore and the group of institution of Sheshadripuram College for giving me this opportunity and also an platform to address the various teachers, faculty members, and the group and the members of the institution to address on one of the very important issue, that is about information, news, and the literacy initiative. I'm very grateful to you, and hopefully this particular session, what I'll be trying to do, will be an eye-opener for you all, because as we all know that media is one such a subject which connects everybody, irrespective of whatever subject we are in, whether we come from management, commerce, science, or arts, or maybe from literature background, whatever be the thing. So this media is such a kind of a subject which connects everybody, and especially getting on to the news, reading the news. So that's the way we are all binded. So this particular session will be for 2 hours. And I was just telling ma'am that it will be I'll be just explaining the importance of this news literacy as well as the literacy initiative. At the same time, even in the end, we'll have some kind of a discussion, which will also open up a lot of ideas for you people. And at the end of the session, we'll see that if we can go in for a discussion on the particular issue, what has been done. Can we go with the slides, please? So I had some issues, so I just requested Fred to do the sliding thing. So this Factshala session, what we are trying to do here is basically to educate the people, not only from the urban areas, but also from the rural class also. But this Factshala training, what we are doing right now is basically training the teachers. We are also been training the media personnel. We are also training the civil society people so that they can get to know what is the importance of the media, how media has to be used. When I say media literacy, it is about how we can assess, how we can analyze, and also how we can interpret the information, because there is a lot of things where the information comes to you, but we are so much overloaded with the information. But as a person or as an individual, are we using this information for the betterment? If you are using this information for a betterment of the society, you know how social media is about. So these are the things which we'll be discussing in the coming slides and all. So, and this, as I told you, this Factshala is a All India Media Literacy Network, which is being done in association with Data Leads as well as with Google India. So Google India, as we all know that Google India is one of the important aspect where they wanted to train the people, and they know the kind of information which happens within the country. So they started this particular training program with the selecting around 250 members across the country, and I'm also one among the certified trainer from Google who is eligible to train the civilians, train the civil society. Especially our target audience are always been the educational institutions and teachers, because we are the people who will be interacting with the young minds. We are the people who get connected to the students. That's the reason why we wanted to have a kind of sensitization of these media literacy should happen at the educational level. So that's the thing. Next slide, please. I'll just keep on telling you. You can just move on to the next slides. So this particular session will have some pictures, will have some case studies so that we can make the subject more interesting. The next slide, please. I'm trying to connect to my laptop because I think it's giving.
Yes, just a second.
Yeah, please go ahead. I'm trying to connect my laptop also. I think it's getting connected. If it gets connected, I'll move on. I can move the slides, no problem for me. So basically, as I told, the main purpose of this Factshala workshop is to educate the people about the misuse of the misinformation, or whatever we call it as the disinformation, which is happening across the world. At the same time, you know that India is a kind of a country, a democratic country where, ma'am, I've been joining from my laptop. If you can just allow me there.
Tejaswi sir,
I'm not getting any request here. I'm waiting for the request, ma'am.
Okay. Move the slide.
Ma'am, I think you need to mute one of the mic either in a laptop or in your mobile. So that is the reason why you are getting echo. You are muted, ma'am, where you have connected in mobile phone. Yeah. Shall I go with the slides?
Yeah, go ahead. Next one. Yeah. Factshala. Is it okay now? Is it echoing?
Yes, ma'am, it is echoing.
So move on to the slides, please.
Yeah, fine.
Thank you. So the reason why we are here today is to train the faculties, and this particular Factshala thing, what I told you, is a news as well as an information literacy program which is being launched in association with Internews, Data Leads, as well as the Google.org. And as I told, the main purpose of our training programs, which I'm doing across the country, is mainly to assess, at the same time to train the people about how critically you can evaluate the information. The next slide. Okay, the main purpose here is we want to train you people because there are three modules which we have usually, and what I'm dealing with today's session is only the first module. So because without telling the people or without letting know the people what kind of information is all about, or what are the kind of information you people get on the mobile, it is very much difficult. So the very first module mainly speaks about the information, the kinds of information which come to you, how you are supposed to assess, how we are supposed to differentiate the different kinds of information. At the same time, what are the different kinds of fake news? Okay, whatever the fake kind of information which comes to you. So that will also be covered in this particular session. So as we all know, why people are running behind this media? The only first and foremost thing is about the information. So when I say information, we are getting so much of overloaded information. Yes, it empowers us, and information is something which will make us more educated. Information will make us more thinkable. We can critically think, we can assess the situations and all. But at the same time, because of this overloaded of the information, we are also becoming more and more crippled. Okay, that is also things which you need to understand. The next one. Just keep the slide for 30 seconds or 20 seconds. That's more than enough for me. Okay, so the main purpose here of this is to see and also to empower the citizens, citizens from different background, citizens from different kind of educational background, cultural background across the country. We are trying to empower these citizens and also trying to make them to navigate towards the super highway, because when I say highway, it is an highway of the information which is there ahead of us. But how we are going to take this information has to be assessed. The next one. So the main purpose of a factuala, this is just an introduction, because as we are associated with the factuala thing, I just wanted to tell you that why this particular factuala thing is there and what are the kind of programs we are doing across the country and the main idea behind this and what are our goals and what are our missions has to be told. I'll be just telling you in the 3 or 4 slides. And as I told earlier, this particular factuala session was being conducted in the metropolitan cities, because we always thought that metropolitan cities are the place where mobile usage is more, or maybe the social media usage is more, because it was initially when mobile made its entrance to the country. So this was the situation. But later on, we got to know that the internet usage has grown over the years, and it has also surpassed the tier 1 city, tier 2 city, or maybe even at the grassroots level or at the village level. So we thought that it is better to target the people even from the tier 2 city and the tier 3 city. So in this particular program, in this particular training program, we'll try to tell you how we are supposed to spot and identify the misinformation. So we as educated also, we have been doing a lot of mistakes, which I'll be telling you in the coming slides, that there are many activities which we do without our knowledge. Though being so educated, though being very media conscious and all, but still we do a lot of mistakes. So that is there. At the same time, we'll also tell you there are different forms of news. Everything which appears on the newspaper or everything which appears in the social media or on the television may not be news. So we'll also train you how you can differentiate. So what are the different forms of news which is available? That is also there. And as a responsible citizen, as we are all educated and as we are all have a very social responsibility towards building a very concrete and a very good society, it is also our responsibility to know and to have access to something trustworthy information, information which is reliable, information which can be usable, at the same time, and information which can be used by the people for something very productive. So that is the reason why, and it is also helps us how we can handle. So there are a huge number of information which comes to you on your WhatsApp every day, and how we are supposed to handle this information. What kind of reaction, how can you react, or how can you be self-reliant, or how can you self-restrict yourself from using these kind of information? Yeah, next one. Okay, so this factuala, as I told you, this is a group of people. We have been training journalists. There are education people from different backgrounds, especially from the media education where I come from. Then we have also been training the civil society, like we have the community leaders, we have the NGO people, we have community radio people at the media education level. So these are the important people who are getting trained. In India, there are around 250 trainers who have been trained by factuala and the Google India, so Internews. So they have trained around 250 people, and these people are from all over the country. From Karnataka, we are around 18 of us who are being trained. As you know, that Google India is not possible for them to train everybody. So they did it through regional wise, and they have selected these people. So it was through application. We applied to the Google India. We got selected, and the training was being done for 5 days. And then the certification was being given. In turn, we can train the people in our locality, in our state. So next slide. So that's how I got into this factuala. And as I told, we have been doing the training programs across the country, length and breadth we have been doing. Earlier, the training was restricted only in English and Hindi. But now we have also taken up the regional languages also, because what we thought was, if you really want to reach out to the masses, especially at the grassroots level or at the rural class level, so we have to be local. At the same time, we have to be local as possible. So that's the reason why there are many regional languages. We have training programs where we conduct, even in Kannada, we do the program. We do it in Assami, then Marathi, Orissa, Tamil, Malayalam. Okay, so we have identified certain 11 languages right now. So we are working on the development of other regional languages also. But right now we have 11 regional languages in which the training program is conducted. The next one. So the thing is, it is not a curriculum which has come overnight. Okay, these curriculum, whatever we have been training, or the modules, whatever we have prepared, these three modules is not done overnight. It is a rigorous, it is a continuous module where we have worked on that, where we have been also been partnering with different organizations. For example, BBC, as you all know, BBC is considered as British Broadcasting Corporation, is being considered as one of the world's best news channel, the television, or maybe the media organization. So these people are also there. We have journalists from the BBC. Then we also have Amity University. We have Hong Kong University. We have Boom. Boom is also one of the the fact checkers from the country. So we have associated with different institutions, different organizations. We have people, resources coming from these organizations. That's how the whole curriculum has been planned, has been designed in such a way that it becomes more interesting. It is more factful. At the same time, it will also have a long-lasting effect on the minds of the people. The next one. So that is how the curriculum has been developed. The next slide, please. So in this session, what is it we are going to cover? In this 1.5 hour of our session, what we are going to cover? The first thing is, we want to see the power of information. I want to speak, because everybody knows, everybody goes through the news, but what is the power of information? Why everybody wants to run behind this information? That's one we'll be seeing. And we'll also check how this information is changing over the period of time. If you go back and if you recall your 10 years back, the kind of news what was there on Delhi Doordarshan, if you go back to our college days and all, we remember that news was completely different. Early we had Delhi Doordarshan or All India Radio to listen to the news. But today there are 896 channels in a different thing. Around 140 news channels are there in India all alone. So that means there has been a lot of changes in the way the information is being given. The landscape is completely changed. And what is the consequence? All information which comes to you, it need not be a good information. So we'll also see what are the consequences which has happened because of this particular information, bad information. We will also see the information neighborhood. Where are these information coming from? What are the important places where we get information? It's not only about the traditional media. It's not about social media, but there are also other information neighborhoods through which you get information. And whether these information is relevant, whether you can use it. So whether you are able to differentiate between the truth and the false thing, that will also be there. They will also speak about the news. And what is news and what is not considered to be news? Because nowadays, whatever comes on TV, whatever we see on our WhatsApp or whatever we see on our social media becomes news. But actually, it is not. Okay, so this particular session will also try to open up and tell you what are the different kind of news and what is different from them. And especially about this online media. How this online media has become one of the place for, it is bubbling with lot of information, and how you need to be very careful. So the very first thing is, let's understand what information is all about. When I say information, what is that information? The next slide, please. So especially in a country like India, where especially a democratic country like India, for anybody to grow, whether you want to grow individually, whether you want to grow as an institution or an organization, information is very much important. So because we all consider that it is more important for any kind of an human progress, the civilized society and all. So without information, everybody knows that why information is important is because without information, we will not be able to understand. It's not only about our understanding or comprehending things, but at the same time, how we are supposed to react to a particular situation. It helps us to react to certain situations, certain events, what is happening in your life. So more informed we are, the more critically the person, critical thinking person, analytical person you are, the more good you can respond to the situation. So when I say the power of information, so these are the things. It will help the individual to grow. So first, second thing, it can also help us to adapt to different kind of a situation. It helps us to evolve. Third thing is, it helps us to improvise our life. It can be our health. It can be the knowledge regarding the political rights, whatever be the thing. But a good information is something which can make a person overall develop, not only in one thing, but in all the particular situations. Yeah, next one. Next slide, please. So at the same time, So the thing is, when we asked the people, stop it here. So when we asked the people about where do you get, okay, yesterday also I was just going through one of the Reuters, because we are a part of this fact checking, we are a part of this Google initiative. I was just taking up some exams and some online tests which was being done by Reuters. So I got to know that 73% of the people in the whole world, even to this day, depend upon especially in Western countries, they depend upon YouTube and Facebook and the social media for getting the information, which is a huge one. That means the traditional media or the newspapers or the radio has completely taken a backseat. People think that whatever appears on the social media is considered to be the news, which it is not. Yeah, next slide, please. So when we ask the people, because when I say the youngsters, especially the youngsters, they say that they don't go through newspapers, they don't go through television, they are just completely hooking on to their social media. They have their own app through which they get the information. But there are also different sources. So when we categorize it, we got to know that radio is there, television is there, magazines, internet, everything is there. Even we have family members. Okay, but gone are the days when people used to think about family members as one of the important source of information. So the thing is, now the challenge for us is, so with these overwhelming flooding of information, how is that you can categorize how the whole world is being so much into this information? So what is the challenge we have and how you can cull out the good information out of it? So let me tell you that the main thing is about the internet. The access of the information can be happening through the internet today. And as you all know, with all this Jio coming up, the Airtel or maybe the BSNL, okay, people have been getting more opportunities. People are getting more and more access to this internet also. But earlier, it used to be an urban phenomena, as I told you. People used to use social media. People used to use mobile, smartphones. It was an urban phenomena, but not anymore. Okay, even if you go to any rural part of Assam or you go to any rural part of Karnataka, any part, even you go to the last region like Yadgiri in Karnataka, you will find people using good smartphones, having an access to the internet, which is facilitated by the internet. So that's the reason why information is not completely something related to urban areas. It is scattered all over, and people from different backgrounds do use this internet. So this is a statistic which I wanted to share with you all, that when you look into the social media scenario, it's already been 15-20 minutes since I started speaking to you all. Per second, 70,000 checks happen or 70,000 searches happen on Google every second. Okay, this is as we are all teachers, and we'll be speaking to our students in the classes or maybe tomorrow. You people can use the statistics because everybody are doing this Googling. Every person, even teachers, or it can be parents, it can be youngsters, everything will look into the Google. So just imagine 70,000 search happens per second. Just imagine 24 hours. How much of a thing, 21 second into 24 hours, just imagine that means what kind of information is loaded in Google, because the same kind of information is not checked with everybody. People do keep changing everything. So that is the one. Second thing is, there are 50 crore blogs which are written in the whole world. Okay, if you look into the thing, every day there are around 50 crores of blogs which are being uploaded. Then 500 hours of YouTube. Okay, when I speak of one of the major social media, it's a YouTube. Okay, people can post their videos and all. Just imagine 500 hours of videos are posted every minute. It's not day, it's not an hour, but every minute, 500 hours. That means just imagine how people are bubbling with information. People want recognition. People want things to be seen. People want things to be put forward. So that means there is a huge option which is available for you. Then at the same time, Facebook, everybody are into Facebook. Even I also use Facebook. Majority of you may be using the Facebook. Every day around 35 crores of photos are uploaded. What kind of photos? That is another kind of a study. That's another thing. But 35 crores of photos are being uploaded every day. I don't think that you'll be able to see all those 35 crores of pictures. But see the amount of information which is flowing into just Facebook. I'm not, and then as I told, 6,000 tweets are also being done. I don't know how many of us are there on tweeting, because Twitter is also one of the best way to get information and also to pass on the information also. Why is this social media? When you look into all these kind of figures and try to see, the main purpose of this thing is social media is an open thing for all. Everyone can be a publisher. Sapna can be a publisher, Professor Somya can be a publisher, Professor Pooja can be one. Okay, so the thing is, each and every one of us have become a publisher. So there is no restrictions as such. So we have that freedom of speech and expression. So people want to connect with the people, organization want to connect with the people, people want to develop their business. So there are many things which has made us much more getting closer to the social media. But whatever comes on these social media is not news. though it look like a news, though it may look like a news for you people, but actually this is not at all a news. So there is something other than the news. Okay, so let's see what are those, the next one. So earlier, as I told, we had this traditional media, we had the social media. So when I say traditional media, it's our regular newspapers, it can be television, it can be radio, where things used to be assessed, thing used to be verified, and the things used to be posted, or it was printed, or it was shown on the television. So there was somebody who used to do this gatekeeping activity, where people used to be very authentic whenever the information goes and which is shown on the TV or which is being printed. But switched over to the social media, one important thing is anything can be posted. So there is no kind of any kind of a verification which happens in the social media. And what happens here is I should have an account. Only thing is Sapna should have an account and I can put anything on the social media, which will become a news, which will for tomorrow's people. And there are a lot of people who wants to see what is being posted. Okay, so the very first thing starts like this. Okay, just you might have seen this. This is Abraham Lincoln. And whenever you get up in the morning, the very first thing what you people usually receive is this kind of messages, which speaks about one particular personality picture would be there. And next to that picture, you will see something called as a quote. Okay, but this is not a real quote. You just see, don't believe everything which is everything you read on the internet just because it has a picture along with it. Okay, I don't know whether this thing has been told by Mahatma Gandhi, whether it is a quote given by our Vivekananda ji. But the thing is, this is the very small way of doing a fake news. But there are many good number of people who tend to believe whatever is there. So that is the reason why we want you people to be very cautious, very what you call intelligent and very educative when it comes to these kind of a thing. Because seeing is believing. Yes, I do agree with this kind of a proverb or the proverb. But the thing is, it's not true all the time. So we need to have that kind of a thinking that whatever you see need not have to be the true thing. So how do you do this? So when in the social media, there are three categories of people. Why we are stressing on all those things is because today everybody is a publisher. Sapna can also publish, Pooja can also publish, or Mr. Tejasvi can also publish. So everybody is a publisher. And we also have a constitutional right which says that you have the freedom of speech and expression, whether I can write, whether I can show, we have everything. But majority of the time it is being misused. So the very question here is, how do you identify these players? So when I categorize these players, there are into three categories. We find three types of people here. The very first kind of people are the creators. So you have a set of people sitting somewhere in Assam, sitting somewhere in Mysore city, sitting somewhere in Afghanistan, sitting somewhere in US. Okay, who are the creators? So their main work is just to create content without fact checking, without knowing anything. So they just create the content. They create memes, they create trolls, they create pictures, they create photographs. There are a lot of people who do this. So these are the people who want to create a kind of a content. So they are called as creators. The second people are the consumers, like we people. So somebody creates something in America or something in US or something in UK, and they post it on their WhatsApp or they post it on FB, they post it on Twitter, and we automatically became the consumers. So that means you see the thing, you receive the content, you assess the content, and you become a consumer automatically. And the last thing is the people who spread it. So we are not only becoming the creators and also we are not consuming, but at the same time, we are also supplying. So what happens? Just hold on to that slide. That is consequence. So the third important, thank you, the distributors. So we are also a distributors. Distributors in the sense, as soon as something comes from the person, from whomever we have the contact, so we are not going to hold on to that. Once it comes, we pass it on to gym group, we pass it on to the college group, we pass it on to the students group. So it keeps multiplying. If it is a good message, fine, well and good. But if it is an unverified, wrong, unethical, illegal kind of a message, just imagine. So the things get multiplied. So the thing is, we are also a part of this distribution. Without knowing, without any kind of a verification, we just pass it on to somebody, and that is how the things are getting multiplied, and the consequences are very harsh. The consequences are also very hard on us. The next one. So now we'll see how we can consequence. So when you have these kind of a bad information which comes to you, what are the kind of consequences? So what can be done? What can be done? The first thing is, these false information can cost life. I'll just start off with some case studies because it will be very easy for us also to understand. Because as you all know, the kind of WhatsApp majority of the people in India are using WhatsApp. Now, somebody, I was just speaking to one of the experts the other day. You know what they said? They said, WhatsApp has become a garbage. It's like a municipality garbage where everybody pukes everything. Everything is being dumped. It can be anything. It can be information. It can be religious. It can be political, entertainment. Everything wants to do something all on the WhatsApp. So it has become a kind of a garbage. So I'll just give you an example. The thing is, during 2019 or 2018, just 2-3 years back, there was a clash in Bangalore. Okay, I wouldn't say the clash in Bangalore, but it spoke about the northeastern students, northeastern people. They said that there are a lot of people who have come down to different parts of the country and they are kidnapping the people and they are selling the people for prostitution, child beggary and all. So again, what happened was, as soon as this particular message started spreading on WhatsApp, people started beating all the people who were there in Bangalore, especially the Assami people, the Manipuri people. Or nodi takshana, they used to think them as they are kaldrugalu tara, makkala kaldrugalu tara. So they were into trafficking, prostitution. They started beating up the people. The reason why I'm telling you all these things is somebody might have created a message. There was no verification. There was nothing. But you may not be aware that during this particular mob, which happened in the state of Karnataka or maybe in the country, around 47 people died. That was just a false information which led to the exodus of people. People wanted to go back to their state. Ella Manipuris, Assamis, yarar idru Bengalurallella kelsa madkondo geldru, they wanted to go back because as soon as you see somebody, they used to think that they are child kidnappers, they're child abductors. Okay, so that was the kind of, that means you wanted to create a kind of an hatred towards that particular community of people or that particular category of people. So that's one example which happened in India. That means false rumors can claim life. Many innocent people died because of that. And this incident happened during the COVID. We are still with the period of COVID. I'll be giving you more examples on COVID because we are in the situation right now. So in Iran, there was a particular rumor which went in the WhatsApp. It said, if you drink more alcohol, it can kill corona, or it can kill, will not be affected by COVID. In this process, 700 people died in Iran last wave. Okay, last wave, 700 people, old people, pregnant women, old children's. Okay, so majority of them, 700 people reportedly died because of this false information. Just one small message: you drink alcohol and you will survive. Okay, so these are the kind of rumors which is very easy for you people to spread. And when this misinformation happened, I'll tell you what is a misinformation, disinformation in the coming slides. So seeing the intensity of this, even to this day, the government and even the Supreme Court ordered that fake news and the panic situation is more dangerous than this pandemic. Okay, we have something called as infodemic. Infodemic anta helidre over usage of the information. Okay, so the Supreme Court came up with the word in March 30th, 2020 only. They came up with this thing saying that India dalli pandemic kinta infodemic e saayisutte anta. That is what is happening. Many of the people are dying because of the fear which is being created by the media. Many of the people are dying. Even you must have seen among your friends, your family members who get very scared. Okay, that is what's happening. So what happened was there was a lot of misinformation which started doing rounds. Like even yesterday, I was just seeing a video, cow urine kudibekante, or you need to have what you call cow dung. If you rub the cow dung along with your faces, we will become pure and the COVID is not going, corona is not going to touch us. So these kind of misinterpretation, these kind of misinformation started spreading mainly because of this social media. And you'll also agree with it that many of the people said, if you drink sanitizer, you are not going to be affected by that. If you keep on doing this, if you keep on lighting the diyas, we have done all those things. Clapping hands can be one of the reasons. Okay, so there are many kind of a misinterpretation, misinformation which happened, which has led to the misinformation. Yeah, next one. Next one. So how this rumor spread, especially go back. How this rumor spread? The first and the foremost thing is there is no verification. I told you the social media has become one of the easiest way of spreading false information. So it starts with a rumor. Then it starts circulating with the people, as you all know. Then it will create a kind of a panic. It can be to create a panic. Sometimes it can be to create a concern also. So it will also start leading to misinformation. Then it will lead to damage of the society. So things have become so, nimge gotirbodu ivaga, especially during corona, people have started becoming very weak by watching, everybody thinks that whatever comes on WhatsApp is a truth, but actually it is not. The reason why we are trying to educate the people is because we want us and we want the family members or the civil society to become much more stronger. Because everybody who is a creator, the person who creates these kind of false information, knows that they play with the fear psychosis. They play with the psychology of the people. And this medium has become one of the easiest way of misleading the people. So by doing so, you are trying to damage the very fabric of the society. The civil society has, nimbu gotirbodo, pharmaceuticals. During the last COVID, we did lot of activity. Even now we are doing. My mother has become an Ayurvedic doctor all of a sudden. My aunt has become an Ayurvedic doctor all of a sudden. Everybody starts their own kind of an interpretation. Adu kudibekante, idu kudibekante. So what has happened here is everybody listens because you are free to do anything. There is no legal action. There is no legal binding. So things have become much more things. So it is one of the easiest way to spread the rumors. The next one. Okay. So just see this particular thing. It is just a picture, a still picture of a child kidnapping. Okay. It shows up. It actually is a video, but we have just used only a small clipping of that, which speaks about Indian child kidnapping. And the line kortare. Okay. They are given the title as this. And this particular video is making rounds in the YouTube, in the WhatsApp. It's been used by many of the people, which says that Bangalore city is not safe. Delhi city is not safe. Lucknow streets are not safe. And the same video, but it is being used in different cities in different kind of a thing. But when we did the cross check, next slide. But when we did the cross checking, we got to know that it is a doctored video. Actually, the video is real, but this video is not from India. But this video is from Pakistan, where it is a public service advertisement which has been created to create awareness among the parents in Karachi. ಕರಾಚಿಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಕಿಡ್ನಾಪಿಂಗ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಜನರುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಅವರಿಗೆ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಎ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವೇರ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಕಿಡ್ನಾಪಿಂಗ್, ದಿಸ್ ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಎ ವಾಸ್ ಡನ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಡಿಡ್ ವಾಸ್, ದ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟರ್ ಯಾರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋ, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಡಿಟೆಡ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದೇರ್ ಕನ್ವೀನಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕ್ಲಿಪ್ಪಿಂಗ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡನ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ, ಬಟ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್. ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಡಾಕ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ಸ್, ಆರ್ ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಸೇ ಎಡಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋ. I'll tell you what are the different kinds of fake things which are being done. So next one. So we need to be very careful whenever you are trying to observe or whenever you get these kind of information on your mobiles, you have to think twice whether it has to be forwarded or whether it has to be not to be forwarded. Okay. So the main part, as I told you, everybody, we become more vulnerable. Okay. People have started manipulating things. Okay. Irrespective, ನಾವ್ ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಎಜುಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಗಳಾಗಿರ್ಲಿ, ನಾವ್ ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಕ್ರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಥಿಂಕರ್ಸ್ ಗಳಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರು ಕೂಡ, ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೂಲ್ ಅಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಈಸಿಲಿ. ವಿ ಟೆನ್ ಟು ಬಿಲೀವ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆನ್ ಮೈ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಶನ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ವನರಬಲ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಗೋ ಹೆಡ್. Okay, fine. Thank you. So now let's see. Yeah, go back. Okay. So there are different kinds of information. So coming back to the information. So with social media, with kind of a hold it has on the society, how people have started using this social media. Let's see what are the different kinds of information. So when I say information, there are two categories of information. One is called as the misinformation. So misinformation is an information which is false. Okay, but the person who is disseminating the information believes that it is true. Okay, for example, Sapna is a person. I am trying to send some information, but I don't know it is a false information, but I think it is true. So I spread the information. For example, it can be a photograph, it can be a small video, a humorous video. Fine, those kind of things are okay. So misinformation is something which is false, but it's not known to me that it is a false information, and I tend to be believed. It is true, and I just keep on sending that message. The next one is what you call as a disinformation. Disinformation is a kind of information which is false. Sapna knows that the information is false, but intentionally she keeps on sending the messages to create a kind of tension in the society. This is called as disinformation. Misinformation is something which is false, which I don't know, but I keep on doing it without my knowledge, so that is okay. But this information is a kind of information which I know it is wrong, but I do purposefully. I want to damage the society. I want to create a kind of tension in the society. Or I do that video very purposefully. I recreate it. I enact it. Okay, so this is what is happening in India. In India, majority of the things what is happening is disinformation. Misinformation is not so harmful, whereas disinformation is very harmful. So I'll tell you with some case studies, you'll get to understand. So this is how the fake things also happen. So when you look into this misinformation, disinformation, this is where you hear this fake news. Okay, there are different kinds of fake news which comes to you. You also know that come to the next slide, because we're not interacting, so you can just go ahead with that. The next slide. So when I say fake news, no, I think go back. Yeah, thank you. So there are 9 different kinds of fake news. Okay, people may be knowing that only 1 or 2 kinds of things, but there are 9 different kinds of fake news which is there on your social media. Okay, the first one, as I told you, can be a misinformation, that is a false information. The second one is a disinformation, which you have created intentionally to create a kind of hatred in the society. I'll tell you with some examples. I'll come to it. Then the third one is the unscientific claim. I told you, drinking cow urine, having the cow dung, or lighting a diya in front of our house will. So all these things are unscientific claims. You people might have known. You people might have seen in the in the social media. There are many unscientific claims. Even to this day, it is happening. The fourth one is the rumors. Okay, there are something called as the hawks and the rumors. People are very good in creating these kind of rumors. Okay, I'll explain with some examples. So there are something called as the rumors. Then false context. Yado ondu vishayana bere yado ondu vishayakke sersi martivi. Okay, so there are certain times where you use different videos in different context. You use different audio in different context. So there is something called as a false context, which is also one of the kind of a fake news. Then you have got imposter content. Okay, imposter content is also one of the way in which you try to spread this information. Then manipulated content. So there are, for example, I told you, somebody was telling me yesterday, I was just going through one of the reports of ICMR, that is the Indian Council for Medical Association, real time, bro. India dalli astu deaths aage illa anta. And somebody in Bangalore, in Mysore also, yesterday there was a news that according to one report of the corporation, 600 people have died due to corona, but the people in the graveyard, the people who burn the COVID bodies, they say that only 120 people have died because of corona. 600 only 120. That means there is a manipulation of the deaths. So that is also one of the way, because they want to create a kind of a tension. I don't know what is the truth. The district administration should give us the truth. But there are many manipulated content, manipulated statistics, which are also given, which is also spread very fastly through WhatsApp. Then the next important thing is the propaganda. So propaganda is especially of religious propagandas happen very frequently in India. Then you have the political propagandas, then you have the cultural propagandas, then you have got food propagandas. There are different kinds of, because India is a multifaceted, multicultural and a multilinguistic society. So each and everybody have got their own value. Okay, we just can't say, because we are like that. We are a democratic country and we should encourage all these kinds of a thing. But there are many people who are misusing this. Okay, especially with the coming up of the social media, people are misusing that. So you need to be very careful. So what are the dangers? Fine, if you have all these kind of things, yen and danger agbodu. The first and one important thing is, people have stopped believing in the reliable sources. People ke government mele namke illa. Okay, government reports are also manipulated. So that means by doing and by seeing all these false reports on your Facebook and on your social media, people have stopped trusting the reliable source. ನಂಬಿಕೆ ಆಹಾರ ಇರೋಂಥ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ಗಳನ್ನೇ ನಂಬ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳೋ ನಂಬ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಓ ನೀವು ಮ್ಯಾನಿಪುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಜನಗಳಿಗೆ ಈ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಅಪ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಂಗ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ. ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಸೇ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಅ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೈ. ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಸೇ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್. I get recovered from COVID, but is leading to black fungus. It is leading to white fungus. It is leading to yellow fungus. So there are a lot of confusion which is happening. But what is the truth? People don't want to listen to the doctors. People want to listen to the religious people. People want to listen to their neighbors who is not a doctor. ನಮ್ಗೆ ರಿಲಯಬಲ್ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಗಳು ಹೇಳೋದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಅಕ್ಕಪಕ್ಕದವ್ರು ಹೇಳೋದು, ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ಹೇಳೋದು ನಮ್ಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್. Okay, the third is, you are successfully doing it because you are very successful in getting the fear. ಜನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಯು ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ದಟ್ ಫಿಯರ್. ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ವೆನ್ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಕೋವಿಡ್? ಪೀಪಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅವಾಯ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಚೈನೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಪೀಪಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅವಾಯ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ಚೈನೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಏನಾಯ್ತು, ಪೀಪಲ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಡಿಂಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಟು ಚೈನಾ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಥಾಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ಚೈನಾ ಆರ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ಎನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಕರೋನಾ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಯು ವೆರ್ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಇನ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪೀಪಲ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸ್ಟೀರಿಯೋಟೈಪ್. ಈಗಲೂ ಕೂಡ ನಿಮ್ಗಳಲ್ಲೂ ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲೂ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಥವಾ ಈವನ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಸ್ಟೀರಿಯೋಟೈಪ್. ಯಾರ ಮನೇಲಿ ಕರೋನಾ ಬರ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಲ್ಲ, ಅವ್ರ ಮನೇಲಿ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು, ಅವ್ರ ಮನೇಲಿ ಇಬ್ರು ಮೂರ್ ಜನ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ಶುಡ್ನ್ ಗೋ ಟು ಹರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದಮ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸ್ಟೀರಿಯೋಟೈಪ್. ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಹೆಲ್ದಿ, ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡೈಡ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡೈಡ್, ಸಾರಿ ಟು ಸೇ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್, ಬಟ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟೀರಿಯೋಟೈಪಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಎಜುಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರು ಕೂಡ ಈವನ್ ವಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಡೂ ದಟ್, ಅಯ್ಯೋ ಅವ್ರ ಮನೆಲ್ಲ ಕರೋನಾ ಆಗಿದೆ ಬೇಡ. Okay, so that kind of a stereotyping has become very much easy because all these, thanks to our social media and thanks to that regular banging of things. Okay, that is also one of the reason why we are doing that. And law and order situation. Okay, especially you know how the law and order situation has been spoiled because of this lockdown, because of this different rules and regulations. Every now and then there is a change of rules and regulations. So that has also become one of the law and order thing. Situation also. But the public health, the reason why we are doing all these things is because public health. Today people are not worried about education, people are not worried about their wealth, only people are related to their health. ಎಷ್ಟೇ ದುಡ್ಡು ಕೊಟ್ಟರು ನಾವು ಬದುಕಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ರಿಚ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಡೈಯಿಂಗ್, ಪೂರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಡೈಯಿಂಗ್, ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರಿಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡೈಯಿಂಗ್, ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಡೈಯಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಕಾನ್ಶಿಯಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್. And health is also very one of the important thing which is being spoiled by this. Then the next one, you can just go to the thing. Next one. So the thing here is, what is more important or what is the most important thing is here, the fake news. Okay, I want to draw your attention towards the things because people are being made to believe it is true. Though it is a false thing, ಹೇಗೆ ಜನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ವಾಶ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಗಳಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದಮ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಟ್ರೂ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎವರ್. ಸೊ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ನೋ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್, ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟೀರಿಯೋಟೈಪಿಂಗ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್, ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಡೆಲಿಬರೇಟ್ಲಿ, ದಿಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಪಗ್ಯಾಂಡಾ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್, ವೆನ್ ಯು ನೋ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ವೇರ್ ಡೂ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್? Where is the situation? How I can start this thing and how I can bring in a kind of a solution? So the next one. So first important thing is, please understand your information neighborhood. Okay, who are these information neighborhood? Yeah, next slide, please. So whatever, please understand that whatever we see on these online or whatever information you see online looks very similar. It looks very same, but everything is not true. So it is our bounded duty to assess this information. The main purpose of our media literacy is to make you people think critically. Being an educated, if I do the mistake, just imagine what happens to a person who is an uneducated, who is an illiterate person, who is somewhere in the rural part of the India. Naave tapp madbekadre avargalu maade martare. Okay, so that has become very thing. The main purpose here is to create a kind of a fear thing. And also mislead the people. I'll tell you how people are misleading. So please understand that each and every information which comes to you, whatever the information which comes to you, whatever you access, will have a different goal. It will have a different purpose. It will have a different set of people. I'll just give you an example. Let the slide be here. I'm just giving a small case study because it will be more interesting for you to understand that. Very recently, there was a Tanishq ad. Okay, a Tanishq ad was being done. As you all know, it was a very controversial ad. Where it's just, I loved that ad very well. You know, just to give you the background, the Muslim mother-in-law will celebrate the baby showering for a Hindu daughter-in-law. That was the thing. And it speaks about harmony. It speaks about the mother and the daughter, or the mother-in-law and the daughter-in-law's relationship. It speaks about the jewelry. It speaks about coming up of the family from two different religions. Fine, that is the kind of thing. And being educated, we accept it. For me personally, it was a very good ad. So just apply that particular Tanishq ad here. What was the thing? As a different purpose. So what was a different purpose? To create or to show a kind of harmony among the people. That was the purpose or the goal of the advertisement. Second thing is, it is done by different kinds of people. See, whenever you're creating an advertisement, 10-15 minds will be working behind it, and that is how a particular ad will be made. So those people may be Christians, they may be Muslims, they may be Hindus, I don't know, because for me, people, caste, religion doesn't matter. What matters is their creativity. What matters to me is the kind of message what it wants to send to the people. So it had different people who have created it. So it goes through different process. So the ad was created. It was been okayed by the people. The client okayed it. The Tanishq people okayed it. Then it was that. Then it went on air. Fine. So what was the intention? The intention was to show that any people, any religion, people can be happy. Okay, or any people, we can bring in a harmony if a baby is being born, and if you are celebrating the pregnancy of a particular girl or a particular woman, it can lead to some kind of a happiness. But what was the message? What was the outcome? There was, as you all, everybody knows about it. Okay, there was a very hue and cry in the society. They said, how come the religious people started speaking? People started attacking the Tanishq showrooms across the country. They said, how can a Hindu girl marry a Muslim? So all those kind of a thing. That means one idea which wanted to celebrate and which wanted to show harmony in the society had different diversions. It was hatred. They spoke about the Muslim religion. They spoke about the Hindu religion. They spoke about different communities, which was not at all necessary. So the thing is, these information, one information can lead to different things. So please understand that how you assess, how you as an individual take up that particular thing matters a lot. So when you look at the different kinds of information, see, information can be a raw information. So information can be in the form of an advertising, because Facebook, it can be advertising. Sometimes it can be in the form of a publicity. Somebody wants to publicize their thing. Somebody wants to publicize their thoughts. So they can be the thing. Then it can be a propaganda. Like political propagandas are there in the country, or like it can be what you call religious propagandas are there in the country. That can also, for some people, these information can be entertainment. Okay, people like this kind of entertainment. Okay, that is also there. Like a husband beating a wife, for some people it is entertainment. Or for some people seeing an accident on the road, it can also be in the form of an entertainment for some people. Please see, journalism comes at the top sixth spot. That means people don't use this as information, whatever is there. It is not at all a journalism. For them, it is entertainment, propaganda and all. For some people, it can be opinion. Sapna has an opinion. Dr. Soumya has an opinion. Dr. Pooja has an opinion. So for this, it can be a opinion also. And last but not the least is a clickbait. I'll tell you what a clickbait, because we have a next slide, which I'll tell you in detail what a clickbait is all about. Yeah, next one. Okay, so as I told, majority of the things, what you see in the Facebook or in your social media, please understand, it is categorized into three things. One is, it can be advertisement form, it can be a propaganda form. Last but not the least, it has got least news value. So adhikoskara yavaglu artha madkobeku baradellanuve news agak sadhya illa. It can be the last component. But the two major component is advertisements and propaganda. In India, majority of the content which comes to you on your social media is entertainment, or sorry, is advertisement, or it is a propaganda material. Okay, the next one. So how will you do this? Just look into this picture. What do you feel when you see this post? Any one of you can unmute and you can say, what do you feel and what do you understand when you see this picture? Any one or two of you, if you can unmute and tell me, what is that thing? What comes to your mind as soon as you see this picture? Anybody, for that matter? Because without that, I can't proceed further. We need to ask that. That's why. Anything. What comes to your mind as soon as you see that picture?
National integration.
Okay. For Dr. Sharda, it is a national integration. Okay, fine. Thank you, ma'am.
Madam, fine. Muslim agra vandu symbol tara kanisutte.
ಹೌದಾ ಓಕೆ ಪೂರ್ಣಿಮಾ ಅವರು ಅಂತ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಏನೋ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ ತರ ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಒಂದು ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಆಯ್ತು ಓಕೆ ಫೈನ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್
ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಡೇ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಷನ್
ಓಕೆ ಫಾರ್ ಅರ್ಚನಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಡೇ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಷನ್ ಫೈನ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಆಲ್ ತ್ರೀ ಫೈನ್ ಸಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಬಟ್ ಆಲ್ ತ್ರೀ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿಟೇಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಶಾರದಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಬಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪೂರ್ಣಿಮಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಶೀ ಸಾ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಏನೋ ಅನ್ಸಿದೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಅರ್ಚನಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಸ್ಪೋಕ್ ಟು ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಡೇನೋ ರಿಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಏನೋ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ Do you think that picture is a real one? Apart from, what is the other thing which is more catchy for you? Yes, fine. Whatever you said, I'll accept it. That's true also. That's fine.
But what is the... Seven wonders of the world.
Yes, good. Asha ma'am says it's the seven wonders of the world. Yes, you have got Burj Dubai, you have got Leaning Tower of Pisa, you have the New York, Liberty there. Okay, fine. Paris Eiffel Tower is there. Fine. Yes, other than that, ma'am, anything else you can observe?
Indian impression on other parts of the country.
Okay, Sridevi ma'am says, it is India's impression on other things. Yes, fine. Thank you, ma'am. That's what I was looking for. See, do you think that this picture is a real one?
Ma'am.
Yeah, tell me, Bharat.
Hello.
Tell me, Bharat. Heli.
Hello.
Tell me, Bharat. I'm listening.
Ma'am, there is a comment comment below which says, fantastic Jai Hind. That maybe adds more patriotism in the social media level.
ಕುತುಬ್ ಮಿನಾರ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯತೆಯ ಬಣ್ಣನ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದಾರ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ.
ಹೌದಾ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹಂಗ ಅನ್ಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ? ಓಕೆ, ಫೈನ್ ಫೈನ್. ಬಟ್ ಆಯ್ತು, ಅದು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಇನ್ನೇನ್ ಅನ್ಸಿಲ್ವಾ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ? ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್, ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳಿದಲ್ಲಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅರ್ಜುನ್ ಹೇಳಿ.
ಕಿರಣ್ ಬೇಡಿ ರಿಪ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಇಟ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಸ್.
Yes, okay, fine. This is what I'm telling you, because everybody, when I asked you people to look into the picture, everybody wanted to see the picture, but none of you people wanted to see who has posted it. The thing is, yaar source anadu thumba important. See, this is a false picture. To be very frank, this kind of thing is not at all there. Whatever you said was correct. It speaks about the patriotism. It speaks about the Indian flag colored, all tricolors are there, but it is a ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಪ್ಯುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್. ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲೂ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಫ್ಲಾಗ್ ನ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಡೆನೂ ಹಾಕೋ ಚಾನ್ಸಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಮೇ ಬಿ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ದೇ ಮೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್ ಇನ್ ಬುರ್ಜ್ ದುಬೈ, ದೇ ಮೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್, ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್. ಬಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಶೇರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇಂಡಿಯಾಸ್ ರಿನೌಂಡ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಷಿಯನ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಗವರ್ನರ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಗವರ್ನರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಐಪಿಎಸ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಕಿರಣ್ ಬೇಡಿ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪಗಾಂಡಾ. ನೀವು ಯಾರು, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಕಿರಣ್ ಬೇಡಿ ಹಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ 15-20 ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಾಲೋವರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಇದನ್ನ ಆಗ್ದಾಗ ಯು ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲಿಸಮ್, ಯು ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಪೇಟ್ರಿಯಾಟಿಸಮ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಾಪಗೇಟ್. ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ನೀ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಪೇಟ್ರಿಯಾಟಿಕ್, ಪೇಟ್ರಿಯಾಟಿಸಮ್ ಇರಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಯಾರು ಅದನ್ನ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಯಾವ ಕಾಂಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದರ ಹಿಂದಿನ ಇದು ಏನು, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ಇಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಚೆಕ್ ದ ಡೇಟ್. ಡೇಟ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ 27ನೇ ತಾರೀಕು ಜನವರಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ 26ನೇ ತಾರೀಕು ರಿಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಡೇ ಇತ್ತು. ಸೊ ರಿಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಡೇನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಲ್ ಓವರ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಡೂ ವಿ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಟ್ ಅಮೆರಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್? ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಡೂ ಇಟ್. ಬಟ್ ವೈ ವಿಲ್ ಅದರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಡೂ ಇಂಡಿಯಾಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್? ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನ್ಯೂಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಪಗ್ಯಾಂಡಾ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಡನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಬೈ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಷಿಯನ್ಸ್, ಇನ್ಫ್ಲೂಯೆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್, ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟ್ಸ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಷಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ಕಿರಣ್ ಬೇಡಿ, ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಡೂ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ಕಿರಣ್ ಬೇಡಿ. ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಇಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಪ್ಯುಲೇಟೆಡ್, ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಟ್ರೂ ಒನ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಯಾರ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಇಂದ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ತುಂಬಾ ವೇಟೇಜ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಅದನ್ನ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡೋರು ಎಷ್ಟು ಜನ ನೋಡಿ, 1700 ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲೈಕ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್, ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಶೇರ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈಡ್. ಬಟ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ರಾಂಗ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ ವೆರಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡನ್. ಬಟ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ವೆರಿಫೈಡ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೋ ವಿತ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಚೆಕ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ನ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಟ್ರೂತ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ, ಅದು ವೆರಿಫೈ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ, ಅಥವಾ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ, ಅಥವಾ ಮಲ್ಟಿಫೆಸೇಟೆಡ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ, ಅಥವಾ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪರೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಈಸಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಇಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಅ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ವಾಚರ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಅ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಈಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದ ಟ್ರೂತ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಐ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ವೇಸ್. ಸೊ ಯಾ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಸೊ ಮೆಜಾರಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಸೀ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್. ಅರ್ಧ ವಿಷಯ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಇನ್ ಮಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ರೆ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಗಳಿರುತ್ತೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಹೋಗಿ, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಹೋಗಿ, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್. ಯಾ, ಗೋ ಹೆಡ್. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್, ಯಾ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಸೊ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಇಸ್ ಪರ್ಸುಯೇಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಪೀಪಲ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಪರ್ಸುಯೇಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದೇರ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ಸ್. ಇದು ನನ್ನ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್, ಇದು ನನ್ನ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಅಂತ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಹೇಳೇ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅನ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್, ಬಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಡೂ ಇಸ್, ಅದನ್ನ ಹೇಳಿ 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 ಅದನ್ನ ನಿಜಾಂಶ ಮಾಡೋ ಜನಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದಾರೆ, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಷಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದ ರಿಲಿಜಿಯಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್. Okay, so you need to be very cautious when you know that there are certain things which is news and there are certain things which is opinion. And usually news na facts barate, when you do the news you will have lot of facts, but whenever you have opinions it is kind of an argument. Okay, you want to put your thoughts ahead, ellru nande helana oppeku ana, it's an opinion but it's not a news. The next one. Go ahead. Yeah, this is the thing. The previous one. Yeah, thank you. So please understand, whenever you look into an info, yade ondu information takondaglu kuda, the facts takondaglu, so these are the five components which will be there. Understand, every information will have facts, every information will have analysis, every information will have opinion, every information will have misinformation, and every information it will have half information. Okay, yavade ondu vishayagalna takondru kuda social media dalli artha facts irutte, 10% facts irutte, ಇನ್ನ 20% ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಇನ್ನ ಅರ್ಧ ಇನ್ನ 60% ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅನಾಲಿಸಿಸ್, ಹಾಗೆ ಹೀಗೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋರೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ. ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ದರ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್, ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅನ್ ಅನಾಲಿಸಿಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಕುಡ್, ಹಾಫ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಮಿಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿಟೇಷನ್, ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಮಿಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿಟೇಷನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ 100% ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಫೈವ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್: ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಅನಾಲಿಸಿಸ್, ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್, ಮಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಯಾ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್. Yeah, fine. So how do you manipulate? So when you look into the social media, when you look our social media, there are very easy way to manipulate the things. Okay, whatever the contents you people find on the social media, so you can manipulate. So yaya tara manipulation janagal martare andre, these are the important one. You can manipulate with the images. Okay, so you can especially there are different kind of softwares are there. Especially our students, even many of my teaching friends are also maybe aware of that. Images can be manipulated. ಯಾರ್ದೋ ಒಬ್ರು ಮುಖ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಯಾರ್ದೋ ಒಬ್ರು ಬಾಡಿ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ, ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಈಸಿ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಫೇಕ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಅದನ್ನ ಕೆಲವರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗದೆ ಇರೋ ತರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಮಾರ್ಫಿಂಗ್, ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಮಾರ್ಫಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದನ್. ಸೊ ಇಮೇಜಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಪುಲೇಟೆಡ್. ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್, ರಿಯಲ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ವುಡ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್, ಬಟ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಯು ಅ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್. ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಡ್ವರ್ಟೈಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ, ವಿತೌಟ್ ಅಫೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿಬಡಿ. When Mamata Banerjee won the West Bengal election, there was one particular video which was going. Mamata Banerjee doddagi joragi football oditare, where Narendra Modi ji stumbles. You might have seen that particular thing. Andre Narendra Modi ji biddiddu nijane, he stumbled somewhere, and Mamata Banerjee kicked football somewhere. That is also real. But you are using that videos in a false context. You are trying to tell that, see how Mamata Banerjee kick a BJP out of the West Bengal, and that other context will it both. So what happens here is, you are using the real images and videos, but you are using it in a false context. Tappu context galli use madodu, that is also one of the way of doing a fake news. Third is real video but false audio. ಆಯ್ತಾ, ಈ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ತುಂಬಾ ನಿಜವಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ನರೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋದಿ ಅವರೇ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಥವಾ ರಾಹುಲ್ ಗಾಂಧಿನೇ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಥವಾ ವೆಂಕಯ್ಯ ನಾಯ್ಡುನೇ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಥವಾ ಅಮಿತಾಬ್ ಬಚ್ಚನೇ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಬಟ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಇಸ್ ರಿಯಲ್, ಬಟ್ ದ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್. ಯು ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಸಂಬಡಿಸ್ ವಾಯ್ಸ್. ಯು ಮೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ದಟ್, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಇನ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ ವೇರ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಕರೋನಾ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಕರೋನಾ ವೇರ್ ರಾಜ್ಕುಮಾರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪುನೀತ್ ರಾಜ್ಕುಮಾರ್, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕರೋನಾ ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಈ ಕಂಬದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆಯಾ, ಈ ಕಂಬದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆಯಾ, ಅದೇನೋ ಒಂದಿದೆ. ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯೂಮರಸ್ ವೇ, ಬಟ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಇಸ್ ರಿಯಲ್, ಬಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಆಡಿಯೋ. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್. ದೆನ್ ಶಾಲೋ ಫೇಕ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಪುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವಿಡಿಯೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಆಫ್ 1 minute, ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ 30 seconds ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅ ರಿಯಲ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ. ಮಧ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಒಂದು ಕೆಟ್ಟದಾಗಿರೋದು ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಇನ್ಸರ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ದೋಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಶಾಲೋ ಫೇಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ, ಅದು ಕೂಡ ಇದೆ. ಡೀಪ್ ಫೇಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ದೆನ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ಮಿಸ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಪುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್. ಸೊ ಐಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಯು ಸಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಐಲ್ ಶೋ ಯು ಸಮ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ, ಸೊ ಇಮೇಜಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಪುಲೇಟೆಡ್, videos can be manipulated, real video and false audio can be manipulated. But the reason why we are believing all these kind of things is because it usually comes from the people whom we trust. Yaake ee tara manipulations galu nambikegalu jaasti aagtave ant helidre, who are the people who send? It is from the college group, it is from the family group. My mother sends, my brother sends, my sister sends. So I trust my brother, I trust my friend, I trust my colleague. So what has happened here is, we don't question them. Okay, if Archana ma'am gets a message from Purnima ma'am or from Soumya ma'am, you tend to believe, because you are all colleagues, you all belong to one particular institution, so you have a particular rapport. So you don't question Soumya ma'am, or you don't question Bharat, or you don't question Purnima ma'am, because we have that kind of a thing. So this has also become one of the weakest point, because all these we have, when we did our research, when we did the sessions and all, when we got to know that 60 to 70% of the information comes from the trusted source. And who are these trusted source? Yara ro tumba nambike yara ivurga moolagalu suti moolagalu yaro antandre namappa namamma nam family members galu. So now avarna nam adenna nambala ant helakagutte. How will a student question a teacher? Madam, how did you send that? I'm not going to believe you, because students tend to believe their teachers. So this is the reason why things have become much more difficult. Yeah, next one. Yeah. So please understand, there are two kinds of things. One, if these are called as two phenomena. The first phenomena is called as a filter bubble. Okay, filter bubble. You know it, Bodo. Filter bubble usually happens in Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. For example, if Bharat has thought of Bharat Yadav ondu idakke hogtare shopping idakke hogtare Myntra will be there. So he clicks on Myntra and he shops something and he leaves it. So the very next day, Bharat in his news feed will get Flipkart, he'll get Amazon advertisements kala or face feed news feed al bartha hogutte, though he hasn't clicked it. So yen agutte, filter bubble is a phenomena where the Facebook will see what is the regular thing, regular historical thing Bharat is seeing every day, then they advertise that on your news feed. Or maybe if Archana ma'am has seen some religious festival, or she has seen some yado venkateshwar ado yado tirupati yado ondu nodirthini atha nane nodirthini tirupati aradhane yado nodirthini. So naale nanage bari religious sai baba adirbodu athwa nanage jagannath puri inda irbodu, all these kinds of religious things keeps coming. The thing is, the people will study the psychology and the history search of a particular person, and it keeps appearing on your news feed. Nimge anusute nanu click madilvalla adya idu vishayagalu bantu anta, but this is a complete way of getting the information to you. This is called as a filter bubble phenomena. Filter bubble phenomena which happens in Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Nisumne Shilpa Shetty yavado ondu particular Instagram account ondu sa nodirthira, next time the Shilpa Shetty nimge bartane irutte, whether you like her or not, you keep getting all the information, all the post of Shilpa Shetty. So this is called as a filter bubble. So this is basically done after searching your history. The next one, the next one is called as an echo chamber. Okay, next one is called as an echo chamber. This echo chamber happens in WhatsApp. Okay, echo chamber anadu, it's a phenomena which happens in what you call as the WhatsApp. I'll just give a small example. You have a group, especially nam college alli irbodu, nim college, everybody will have a group. Okay, so another example, I'll give you my example how it works in the echo chamber. Sapna's birthday is there, so we have a group of 60 students in the class. So somebody says, Sapna ma'am, today is your birthday, so happy birthday. Okay, so one person puts, Mr. A puts, happy birthday Sapna ma'am. All 60 have to put Sapna ma'am birthday and akle beko. They don't verify whether it is Sapna's birthday or not, whether they like Sapna or not. They have to post it, because you have to be a part of that particular group. So echo chamber is a phenomena which helps the people to repeat the same kind of a thing without thinking. Neevu yochane madak hogadilla adu sari idya tappu idya, because you want to be in the group. If you don't wish your secretary, or if you don't wish your Sapna ma'am tomorrow, you will be out of the group. Or maybe she will say the Sapna will have an eye on you. Okay Sapna, why you didn't wish me on that particular day? So irutha tara. So what happens here is, you want to go with the flow, with a intention that if I don't wish Sapna ma'am tomorrow, I may be put aside or I may be targeted. So what, whether you like it or not, you join the group. So this kind of phenomena is called as an echo group, echo chamber, which happens very common in your family group al nodirbodu neevu, especially whether you like it or not. You have to like the picture, whether you have to comment on that picture, whether you like that particular person or not. Andre enagoguthe andre, you want to have that kind of a psychology. So this is called as an echo chamber, which is very common in all the WhatsApp thing. Okay, the next one, the next one. So BBC has come up with this kind of a thing. The next one, we'll not doing any kind of exercise, so we can just go ahead. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, thank you. So there are different, okay, go back, the types of, okay, so there are different types of misleading content. So when you look into the types of content on the online media, so we will get different kinds of content. The very first one is what you called as the propaganda. The first one, yeah, so this is a propaganda. Just look into that picture and you will see this particular picture is posted by one MLA from Madhya Pradesh called as Jitu Patwari. Jeetu Patwari has posted his picture. He's a congressman. And he says, look at the picture. Look at how Narendra Modi ji's flight is there. See the kind of pomp and pompous with this aircraft. ಅದೇನೋ ಬರ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಅದನ್ನ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಶೇರ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್, ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲೈಕ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಬಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಡಿಡ್ ದ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಚೆಕ್, ಓಕೆ, ವಿ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಸೀ ವೆದರ್ ಸೀರಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ನರೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋದಿಜಿಸ್ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಂತ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಡಿಡ್ ದ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಚೆಕ್, ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ನರೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋದಿಜಿಸ್ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಬೋಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಲರ್, 787 ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು. ಅದು ಎಜುಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ನಮಗ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಜೀತು ಪಟ್ವಾರಿ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಎಂ ಎಲ್ ಎ, ಹಿ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಎಂ ಎಲ್ ಎ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಎನಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆರಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್, ಪೀಪಲ್ ಬ್ಲೈಂಡ್ಲಿ ಫಾಲೋ ಹಿಮ್. ಜನಗಳು ಅವನ್ನ ತುಂಬಾ ನಂಬ್ಕೊಂಡಿರೋನ್ ಅಂತ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರು ಒಬ್ರು ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಲಕ್ಷಾಂಗಟ್ಲೆ ಜನ ಆಗ್ಲೇ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರೀಪೋಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪಗ್ಯಾಂಡಾ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್. I'm not supporting Congress, I'm not supporting BJP, I'm not supporting anybody. But the thing is, politicians use this forum especially to do kind of propaganda. ಓಕೆ, ನೀವು ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಷಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ಎಲ್ಲಾರ್ದು ಅಕೌಂಟ್ಸ್ ಗಳಿದೆ, ಜನಗಳಿಗೆ ಇದು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇರಂಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಜನಗಳಿಗೆ ಹತ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ, ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕಿಟ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಪೀಪಲ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಬಿ, ಪೀಪಲ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ. 10% ಪೀಪಲ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಜೆನ್ವಿನ್, ಬಟ್ 90% ಆಫ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಪಗ್ಯಾಂಡಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲ್ ಹೂಮ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್. ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಿಸ್ಲೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಕಾಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಬೇಟ್. I told you this is also one of the important thing, what you call as a clickbait. As the name itself suggests, bait is nothing but meenge gaala aakadu anta. Okay, bait is something where the fish goes and bites the thing. And as you all know, today whole of the world depends upon the click. You get famous when you click, when you share, when you like, when you subscribe, you know, all those things kind of a thing. So you have to create a content on the social media, on your website or on your thing, only when people start liking it. ಸೊ ಏನಾಗೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಓಪನ್ ಅಪ್ ಸಮ್ ಗೂಗಲ್ ಆರ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಓಪನ್ ಅ ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ ಅಂತ ಏನೋ ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಓಪನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ, ಯು ಆಲ್ ಬಿ ವಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ವಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸಡನ್ ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಕಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಥಾಟ್, ಯು ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಆನ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಬಟನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಬಟನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಇಟ್, ಬಟ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ದ ಟ್ರೂತ್ ಒನ್. ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಟು ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ರಿಲೇಶನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್, ದ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಬೈಟ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈಗಿನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮನಿ. ಎಷ್ಟು ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ದುಡ್ಡು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಒನ್ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 20,000 rupees, ಒನ್ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಆಫ್ ರುಪೀಸ್. ಸೊ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್, ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲೈಕಿಂಗ್, ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್, ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಈಸಿಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟು ಮಿಸ್ಲೀಡ್ ದೆಮ್ ಟು ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಬೈಟ್. ಇದು ಕೂಡ ವೆರಿ ಕಾಮನ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ನಾವುಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದ್ಸಲಿ, ಓ ವಿ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದ ಡಾಲರ್ ಪ್ರೈಸ್, ಬಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಇಟ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಡಾಲರ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್. And that will lead to something else. Click Martha, 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 you will go to something else. So this is one of the important way of misleading the people. Okay, the third one is called as sponsored content. Okay, so these sponsored content you people can see in the Facebook. Okay, so this is one example I've given it. This is a BuzzFeed. Okay, I've got a news portal. So you're reading the expert there. But all of a sudden, there is also one more important advertisement. I'll just give an example of a Facebook. ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀರಾ ಸಡನ್ ಆಗಿ, ಅಥವಾ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀರಾ, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಸೀರಿಯಲ್ ಆರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವಾಚಿಂಗ್, ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸಡನ್ ಅಡ್ವರ್ಟೈಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಪ್, ಒಂದು ಅಡ್ವರ್ಟೈಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಪ್ಸ್ ಅಪ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಡ್ವರ್ಟೈಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಸೂನ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಡ್ವರ್ಟೈಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಪ್ಸ್ ಅಪ್, ಯುವರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಮೇನ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿ ಅಡ್ವರ್ಟೈಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ದೋ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ 5 seconds, ಸ್ಕಿಪ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 5 seconds ಅಂತ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಇಟ್, ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಕಿಪ್ ದ ಅಡ್ವರ್ಟೈಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಬಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ who will go to that particular content and start watching that. Okay, so this is also one of sponsored content is something where things are intentionally fed or the things are intentionally planted in the main content so that they get more viewership. Okay, this is also very common in Facebook and all of a sudden on the other pop up agutte nanu yado film nortta irthe suddenly I'll go to advertisement, advertisement innond advertisement to atra, it keeps on changing. That is also called as a sponsored content. Okay, that they do it very intentionally, especially the advertisers, the manufacturers and the corporates, they always do these kind of a planted sponsored content. Okay, because they get money out of it. Okay, the next one, the next kind of the thing is called as a satire or hoax. Okay, the satire or hoax. Just look into these logos. Can you see any difference? Anything which comes to your mind as soon as you see that? If you people have been watching a news channel, you'll easily be able to make out. Yeah, ma'am? Pratima, ma'am?
Yeah, news channel.
Yeah, news channel. How though? Tell me, ma'am. What is that you found?
Times now has been changed as Times How.
Okay, fine. See, just because you observed, you got to know that it is Times Now. The logo is the same. The font is the same. The color is the same. But they have written as Times How. Okay, even LOI is Times of India, but it is written as Limes of India. Okay, so what has happened here is, these are also many different ways of the hawks madadu enante helidre logo ke janagalige logo bagge gnyapaka jaasti irutte, like Fair and Lovely or Parle G biscuit. Namge adu talayalli eshtu we have got engraved ante helidre aa Parle G spelling tappidru kuda naavu tagoltivi yakandre magu nodkonu tagoltivi. We will be so much used to that logo, or we will be used to that particular color. ಮನೆಗೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ನೋಡ್ತೀವಿ ಸ್ಪೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ತಪ್ಪಿರುತ್ತೆ. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಫೇಕ್ ಒನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಫೇಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್. ಇನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ವೇ ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆನಿ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆನಿ ಟೆಲಿವಿಷನ್ ಚಾನೆಲ್ಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಫೀಡ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯೂಶಲಿ ಆರ್ ಮಿಸ್ಲೀಡಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಲೋಗೋನ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ ವರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಬಟ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಅವರ್ ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ವಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಆನ್ ದಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ನ ನೋಡಿ, ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ನೌ ನ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ಅಂತ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. LOI, that is Times of India, but it is written as Limes of India. But without cross verification, atwa hari barili, we'll click it on LOI. So obviously you are seeing that particular website or you are seeing that particular news website. So this is also one of the way in which it's very easy to trap the people. Now educated galagidke gottu namge, but think of the uneducated people. Yadon product, yadon government scheme ide, government adi ide anta helkon madod kuda, they do that. And the next kind of content is what you call as an error. Okay, so error is something which is done not done purposefully, but it happens from the people also. Like I may also commit a mistake, you may also commit a mistake, but it is also something which lead to the confusion in the minds of the people. I've just taken up the example of Rajdeep Sardesai. People might be knowing Rajdeep Sardesai is one of the India's renowned journalist who was the editor of and he was the editor of NDTV, then he was with CNN, IBN and all. Okay, so as we all know, some days back or maybe some years back, Pranab Mukherjee, our president, former president, was on ventilation. He was not keeping well, so he was on ventilation. So somebody posted or somebody tweeted saying that Pranab Mukherjee passed away. Okay, so without any cross verification, the journalist, okay, one of the main function of a journalist is to cross verify, but without a second thought, Rajdeep Sardesai tweeted saying that, oh, rest in peace Pranabda, okay, farewell to Pranabda, lot of memories, that this and all, around 8:55 in the morning, 8:59 he just did the thing. The very next moment, the son of Pranab Mukherjee tweeted saying that my father is still alive, he's still on ventilation, Mr. Rajdeep Sardesai, he hasn't passed away, and the kalistara. So the next again thing is you verify the puna after half an hour again Rajdeep Sardesai message saying that being such a good journalist, I fell prey for this kind of a fake message. Without cross verification, I tweeted, and that tweeted was been made a news, it was been circulated, it was retweeted. You know how people are. So that means being a good journalist, your main instinct is to cross verify the source. Tappa sarina adu tilkondo ni post maadbekagide avurdu sadanaagi ni maadbitre andre breaking news nane first maadbeku anta situations galalli we tend to post certain things without verification. That is a very big error. Okay, just imagine, it can be a bomb blast tomorrow, it can be an attack, I don't know. Ondu sanna tappu janagalalli thumba fear na moods anta idu bandibidirutte. So that is the thing is, what when I say error, it means that even big personalities like him can commit mistake. Then what about ordinary people like us? What about a common person like us? We tend to follow this error for a longer time. Okay, the next one. Next you have something called as a partisan. Okay, partisan and the one day picture, but many claim that. Okay, for example, just look into this picture. The picture shows a man standing on the tricolor, that is our Indian national flag, and he is wearing a Pakistani flag on him. The same picture is being used in different places, especially in a place like Lucknow, places where there is lot of one particular class of community. Okay, one particular class of community. So when we did the cross checking, when we did the fact check, we got to know that. And the yen and India Dali Iranta one the particular community or the Muslim community bage on the hatred na madbeko on the head. These kind of pictures are being used. The same picture, but it is used in the different places, like in Lucknow, because Lucknow is a place where this particular community people are more in number. In Hyderabad, because that is a place where a lot of this particular community people are there. So, but when we did the fact checking, we got to know that this picture is not from India. This picture is basically from Karachi, a Pakistani thing. And in India, you can't do these kind of a thing because it is illegal. It is unconstitutional. Okay, you can be arrested for disrespecting the flag. But when you do these kind of things, postings on the social media, you will start hating that community people, whether they have done the mistakes or not. Yenagogutha a particular community bage ondu hatred baruk shuru agutte, a particular person bage ondu hatred baruk shuru agutte. So we do all these kind of things. It not have to be community only, it can be culture, it can be women, okay, it can be some LGBT bage. Okay, there are many things. Even very recently kuda vandene notirbodu one political party has used only one person, one amma anta maadkondo ella politicians galu ade amma. Okay, only the person has changed. Mother is the same, but the politicians have been changed in all the pictures. That was also, it also went viral. That is the best examples of partisan, where the same picture is used for different contexts. Yeah, next one. Conspiracy theory. Nammala aitala, conspiracy theory. The best example I would give you for a conspiracy theory is where you want to assassinate or you want to corner somebody. I'll just give an example. Again, I'm telling you because COVID example I'm taking because we are passing through that particular phase and we are also conspiracy theory. As soon as the vaccine came to India, I can give you one or two examples. When vaccine came to India in the initial period during the last month of January, February, when the Indian government started this vaccination drive in India, Akhilesh Yadav, that is the Samajwadi Party person, he said, no. He came up on the stage. He came on TV. It was a live telecasted. He said, no. I am not going to take this vaccine because this vaccine is done by the BJP party. And I'm not going to take this vaccine because BJP will kill us. And the one statement put wrong. It's a very fact. Everybody, you can cross check with the videos and all. He said, as soon as that comment came from Akhilesh Yadav, all the people who are following Samajwadi party in UP didn't want it to take the vaccine. See here, it is not the party which is important. It is the life of the people which is important. But it was a kind of a conspiracy theory on one particular party or one particular religion, one particular thing you try to do it. In India, it is a very common thing. Okay, it's a very common thing to have this conspiracy theory where you want to target somebody and you do this. I told you about this Tanishq. It was a conspiracy theory to speak about one religion. That is also there. One more example was, again, one more example, best example I could give you here is about Tablikis. Okay, Tablikis. Last COVID, alli, a Tablikis bandru aur kalindane ella aitu ante eshtu jana navu idu madidvi. We did that, right? We had that. That means because of this particular community people we had, I'm not offending anybody here, but it's a reality. That's what happened. And that's the example. Without respect, without offending any of the religion or any of the party, I'm just telling you the facts because we are from journalism and we want to look into the facts. ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ತಬ್ಲಿಕೀಸ್ ಆತರ ಆದಾಗ ಅವರಿಂದನೇ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಂತು ಯಾರು ಅವ್ರ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಡಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಡಿ ಮಾಸ್ಕ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಡಿ ಅಂತ ಅದು ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಈ ಸಲಿ ಕುಂಭಮೇಳ, ಓಕೆ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡರ್, ಓಕೆ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಇರೋ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ವೇವ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕುಂಭಮೇಳ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಟು. ಇವಾಗ ಯಾಕೆ ಯಾರು ಟಾರ್ಗೆಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ? ವೈ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟಾರ್ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ಹಿಂದೂಸ್ ದೆನ್? ವೈ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟಾರ್ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟೀಸ್ ದೆನ್? So this is the reason why that conspiracy theories are also being making rounds on the social media. So we should not fall prey for all these kind of, that is my main concern. The next important kind of a conspiracy, the next important kind of a content is the pseudoscience. Okay, pseudoscience is something where people come up with their own theories. Okay, own theory. Naan en doctor en alla, I told you my mother is not a doctor, but she all during corona they have become the Ayurvedic doctors. Ashna akun kudibekanta, there is there. Turmeric is a very good, where it has been proven scientifically. Pooja maadbekante, cow urine kudibekante, okay, lime kutinbekante, jaasti, masala tinbekante, janagalu spicy tintare Indians, so namge COVID baralla. So these are some of the kind of a pseudoscience which is not scientifically proven. But still, it is making rounds still we also follow, we have been following that, okay? We have been following, you also know that. We unknowingly or knowingly, we have been following that kind of a thing. ದೀಪಾಚಬೇಕಂತ ಹಚ್ಚಿದ್ವಿ, ದೀಪ ಹಚ್ಚಿದ್ವಿ, ಕ್ಲಾಪ್ ಹೊಡಿಬೇಕಂತ ಅದು ಕ್ಲಾಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ, ಪಾತ್ರೆ ಶಬ್ದ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಬೆಲ್ ಹೊಡ್ವಿ, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಎ ಸೂಡೋ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ಕ್ಲೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಡನ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಎನಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ವೆರಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್, ಎನಿ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ಅಪ್ರೋಚ್ ಗಳು ಆಗದೇನೆ ವಿ ಬಿಲೀವ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಥಿಂಗ್ ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಆಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸೂಡೋ ಸೈನ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾನಾವತಿ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಇಂದ ಬಂದಿದ್ದು ಅಂತ, ದೆನ್ ಲೆಟರ್ ಆನ್ ದೇ ಸೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ನೋ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ರಾಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನಾನಾವತಿ. ಬಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸಿಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಟರ್ಮರಿಕ್, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಇಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅದರಿಂದ ರೋಗನ ತಡೀಬಹುದು. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕಲಿ ಪ್ರೂವನ್. ಬಟ್ ಸುಮ್ ಸುಮ್ನೆ ನೀವು ಮಸಾಲ ತಿನ್ಬೇಕು, ನೀವು ಅದು ತಿನ್ಬೇಕು ಸಿಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ರಾಂಗ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೂಡೋ ಸೈನ್ಸ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಆನ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಆರ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್, ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಎ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್, ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೀವು ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು ಮೂಗಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂತೆ, ಬಿಸಿನೀರ್ ಕುಡಿಬೇಕಂತೆ, ನೀವು ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು ಆ ತರ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದ್ ಜನ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಅಥವಾ ಹಾವಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕಂತೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟೀಮ್ ಸೊ ಕೊರೋನಾ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಮ್, ಕೋವಿಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೈ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸಡನ್. ಬಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋ, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡನ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೀಮ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕಲಿ ಪ್ರೂವನ್. ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡೂ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕಲಿ ಡನ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, misinformation. I told you misinformation is something which is being spread among the people, but it doesn't have any arm. So illi one picture hakidare nodi, it says what a beautiful football stadium in Manipur anta kottidare. Okay, so that is being shared. Oh, very good, lucky we have got this kind, because Manipur is one of the state in India apart from Kerala and Bengal where more football is played. Okay, but when we did the cross checking, we got to know that this picture is not from Manipur, but it is from Russia. ಓಕೆ, ಮಾಸ್ಕೋ ದಲ್ಲಿ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ರಷ್ಯಾ, ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ತಗೊಂಡು ಇದು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಹಾರ್ಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಮಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್, ಓಕೆ, ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ ಇಟ್. ಬಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಆಫ್ ಅ ರೇಪ್, ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಆಫ್ ಅ ವಿಮೆನ್ ಬಿಂಗ್ ಚಾಪ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್, ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಗರ್ಲ್ ಬಿಂಗ್ ಹರಾಸ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಷನ್, ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ. Okay, so adike helidhu, whenever you are choosing a picture, whenever you are choosing some videos which you want to post, you have to be very careful, because it may not affect Sapna, it may not affect Archana ma'am, it may not affect Pratima, it may not affect Purnima ma'am, but there will be lot of people who will be affected. Yaro ond husband or wife ke odithara video na nan nale adna post madidre, there will be some kind of a mindset of a man who wants to do the same thing to his wife. The repercussions are very huge. Nanage harm agde irbodu ಅಥವಾ ನಮ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿಗೆ ಆಗದಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಬಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಇನ್ ಅಫ್ಘಾನಿಸ್ತಾನ್, ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಬೀನ್ ಡನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಬೀನ್ ಬೀಟನ್ ಅಪ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೆಮ್ ಟು ಸೆಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್ ವೈ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ರಿಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಡೌಟ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಕಾಶಿಯಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ರೆಪರ್ಕಷನ್ ಸಮ್ವೇರ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಓಕೆ, ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಬೋಗಸ್. Okay, the bogus is, as I told you, there was naale banamalella barithare nodirbodu, if you there is one particular thing which comes to our WhatsApp which says today is Sai Baba's birthday, please forward this Sai Baba mantra to 15 of your friends, if not a bad omen will happen to you anta bar nodirbodu alva. Bogus adu, we know that, but still, even though I am a Sai Baba follower, I do Sai Baba following and all, when that kind of a message comes to me, think madbek nanu, I should do or not, but we do that. Okay, we forward it to some 10 15 contacts so that I'll be safe. We know that it is a bogus. These kind of things is also one of the important thing what we do. Athwa archane madbekante nu nodirbodu ammagalgellanu green sari kodbekante bale kodbekante adu kodbekante idu nodirbodu nivella. Those are all the bogus things where you try to create a kind of tension, you try to create a market for something. ಅಮ್ಮಗಳಿಗೆ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಸಾರಿನೇ ಕೊಡಿಸ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ, ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ಇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಡೂ. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಡೂ, ಫೈನ್, ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಆಯ್ತು, ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್, ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಪಗಾಂಡಾ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಬೋಗಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಎರರ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಪಿರಸಿ ಥಿಯರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ವೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ದ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಫೇಕ್. ಬಟ್ ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ದನ್? ಆಯ್ತು, ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಆಯ್ತು, ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ದೆನ್? So what is it we are supposed to do? Being an educated, being an academician, being a teacher tomorrow, what is it I can do? Or what is it I can do as a civil society? And next one, the first and the foremost thing is, there are four things which you have to understand. One is, ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದ ಸೋರ್ಸ್, ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ವಿಷಯಗಳು ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ಇಟ್, ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್. ಮೆನಿ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ನೋ ಹೂ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಇಟ್. ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ರೈಟ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟರ್ಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಅವೇರ್ ದಟ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದ ಸೋರ್ಸ್, ಯಾರ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬಂತು, ಯಾರ್ ಕಳ್ಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಏನು ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಲೇಮ್ಸ್ ಏನಾರು ಇದೆಯಾ, ಅಥವಾ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಂದ ಏನಾರು ಬಂದಿದ್ಯಾ, ವೈ ವಿಲ್ ಐ ಬಿಲೀವ್, ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, ವೆರಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಯಾವ ಸುದ್ದಿ ಮೂಲದಿಂದ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಅದು ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ತಿನಾ, ಎನ್ ಡಿ ಟಿವಿ ಇಂದ ಬಂದಿದ್ಯಾ, ಟಿವಿ ನೈನ್ ಇಂದ ಬಂದಿದ್ಯಾ. ಟಿವಿ ನೈನ್ ಬಂದಿದ್ರೆ ನಂಬೇಕಂತ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಟಿವಿ ನೈನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬಿ ಬೋಗಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬಿ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಪ್ಯುಲೇಟೆಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಒನ್, ಬಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಟ್ ವೆರಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್. ಥರ್ಡ್, ಏನೇ ಇದ್ರು ಕೂಡ ಎವಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆಯಾ, ಎವಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್, ಎವಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಫೋಟೋಗ್ರಾಫ್, ಎವಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಡಿಯೋ ಕ್ಲಿಪ್ಪಿಂಗ್ ಇದೆಯಾ, ಅಥವಾ ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಾ, ವೆದರ್ ದಟ್ ಆಡಿಯೋ ಇಸ್ ರಾಂಗ್, ವೆದರ್ ದ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ರಾಂಗ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್. ಮತ್ತೆ ಡೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್, ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ದ ಡೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್, ಲೈಕ್ ಇನ್ ಕಿರಣ್ ಬೇಡಿಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಐ ಶೋಡ್ ಯು ದ ಡೇಟ್ ಆಸ್ 27 ಜನವರಿ. ಯಾಕೆ 27 ಜನವರಿಗೆ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಡೇ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ರಿಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಡೇ. ಇಫ್ ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಆನ್ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಡೇ ಲೈಕ್ June 25th ಆರ್ July 25th, ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ರೆಲೆವೆನ್ಸ್. That means you should understand that is somebody is doing it for other things. So that is also very much important. You have to check the date, check the publication. Then if nothing is going to work out, please ask the expert. Like cow urine kudutakshana nane corona hogutta, no, the doctors will say. It is not the astrologer who has to say, it is not the politician who has to say, it is not Sapna who can say, it is the doctors who have to tell that yes, if you do this, it is not going to happen. If you take the vaccine, you can stay for 90 days without any kind of a harm. And the doctors in the helbeke vartu, politicians or DC galu heladalla. Okay, so that's the reason why you have to trust the expert, the person. For example, if the management teacher says something, then it has some value because she is an expert in that. If the communication teachers like me who say something about media, then it is trustworthy. I can't speak about statistician, I can't speak about management because I'm not an expert in that. ಬಟ್ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ, ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ತರ ವಿಷಯಗಳು ಮಾತಾಡಕ್ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವೇರ್ ದ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್, ವೇರ್ ದ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ವೆರಿಫೈಡ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಅನಾಲಿಸಿಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಅನೈಸ್ ಅಂತ ಬರ್ತಲ್ಲ ಇದಕ್ಕ, ಓಕೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಯಾ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಕಾಲ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಎಸ್ ಅನೈಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಲಿಟ್ರಸಿ, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಸಿ ಎನಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್, ವೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್, ಯು ಸಿ ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಥಾರಿಟಿ. ಇಫ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಕಮ್ಸ್, ಇಫ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಷಿಯನ್, ಸಿ ವೆದರ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಅಥಾರಿಟಿ ಆರ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರ್ಟ್ ಇದೆಯಾ. ಇಫ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಐಮ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಇಫ್ ಲಿಂಬಾವಳಿ, ಓಕೆ, ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ, ಅರಣ್ಯ ಇಲಾಖೆ ಅವರು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸೇ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಲೀವಬಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಸುಧಾಕರ್ ಸೇ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್. ಐ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ಇಫ್ ಸಿ ಟಿ ರವಿ ಸೇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್. ಇಫ್ ಈ ಸ್ಪೇಕ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್, ಐ ನೋಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿಲೀವ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್, ವೆದರ್ ಈ ಇಸ್ ಎನ್ ಅಥಾರಿಟಿ, ಅವ್ರು ಮಾತಾಡೋ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಇದೆಯಾ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇದ್ದವ್ರು ಮಾತ್ರ ಅದು ಮಾತಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಹೋಗ್ತೀನಿ ಯಾರು ಮಾತಾಡೋ ನಾನು ನಂಬಕ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಇಫ್ ಸಚಿನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಗುಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್, ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸೇ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಚೆಸ್, ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ಇಮ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಚೆಸ್. ಇಫ್ ವಿಶ್ವನಾಥ್ ಆನಂದ್ ಸೇಸ್, ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್, ಇನ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋ, ಇನ್ ದ ಆಡಿಯೋ ಕ್ಲಿಪಿಂಗ್. ಸಂಬಡಿ ಸೇಸ್, ಓ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದರ್ಶನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್, ಇದು ಮಾಡಿ ಅದು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು. ದರ್ಶನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ರೈಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಫಿಲಮ್ ಆಕ್ಟರ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯಾರು ಜನರು ಅವ್ರ ಹೇಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೊಪಗಂಡಾ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲ್ ವೆನ್ ಡೀಲಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್. ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್, ಸಿ ವೆದರ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಇದೆಯಾ ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಮೆನಿ ಅ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸೂಡೋ ನೇಮ್, ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ನೇಮ್. ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ತಪ್ಪ ತಪ್ಪು ಹೆಸರುಗಳಿಂದ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಅವರ ನಿಜವಾದ ಹೆಸರುಗಳಿಂದ ಬರಕ್ ಹೋಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಲ್ ಬಿ ವೇರಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಕ್ರಾಸ್, ಇಲ್ ಬಿ ವೇರಿಂಗ್ ಅ ತಾತಿ, ಆರ್ ಇಲ್ ಬಿ ವೇರಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಮೇಕ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಟು ದಟ್. ಬಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಈ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹಿಂದೂಯಿಸಮ್, ಓಕೆ, ಸಿ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ನೇಮ್ಡ್, ಅದ್ ನೇಮ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ ಅಥಾರಿಟಿ. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ AIMMS, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೂ. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಾಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಹೂ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಇಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಸಿ ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದಾರಾ ಇಲ್ವಾ ಅಂತ. ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಚೆಕ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ದೆನ್ ಕೊರಾಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಡಾಕ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಬಿಲೀವ್ ದಟ್. Okay, that is also one of the way in which you can understand. Then evidences. You, especially in the media or especially in the news channels and newspapers, we don't believe anything without evidence. So evidence is very much important. Evidence can be a photograph. Evidence can be a draft. Evidence can be a police FIR. Inara agirbodo. Okay, or any evidence can be a court proceedings. ಪಾರ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟರಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು, ನೀವೇ ನೋಡಿರ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀರಾ, ಈ ಎರಡ್ ಮೂರು ದಿವಸದಿಂದ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಡಿಸೈಡೆಡ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಅವೇ 1 month ಸ್ಯಾಲರಿ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಫೀಷಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಬಂತು. ಓಕೆ, ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಶುರು ಆಗೋಯ್ತು. ಓಕೆ, ಓ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಫೀಷಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ಹೆಂಗೆ ದುಡ್ಡು ತೊಗೊಳಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಒಂದು ತಿಂಗಳ ಸ್ಯಾಲರಿ ಹಿಂಗೆ ತೊಗೊಳಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ. ಬಟ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಆನ್ ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಫೇಕ್ ಒನ್. ಅದು ಬಂದಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ದ ವೆರಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡೇ ದ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್ ಅನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್, ನೋ ನೋ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ 1 month ಸ್ಯಾಲರಿ, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ 1 day ಸ್ಯಾಲರಿ. ಸೊ ಏನ್ ಎವಿಡೆನ್ಸ್? ಜನಗಳಿಗೆ ಅದು ಪ್ರತಿ ಬಂದಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಲೋಗೋ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸಿಗ್ನೇಚರ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ದಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಮಾರ್ಫ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಂತ ಡೇಟ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ, ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಹೋದ ವರ್ಷದ ಒಂದು 10 ವರ್ಷದ ಹಿಂದ್ಗಡೆ ತಗೊಂಡ್ಬಂದು ಈ ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಡೂ ಇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್. ವೆರಿ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗಿವ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ವೈಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಪ್. ಸರ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಒಂದು ವಿಡಿಯೋನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ವೆರಿ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ಲಿ, ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ವೆನ್ ಕಮಲಾ ಹ್ಯಾರಿಸ್ ಟುಕ್ ಓವರ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್, ವೈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುಎಸ್, ಯುಎಸ್ಎ, ವೆನ್ ಶಿ ಟುಕ್ ಓವರ್. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಒನ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ವಿಚ್ ವಾಸ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ರೌಂಡ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಸಿ ಕಮಲಾ ಹ್ಯಾರಿಸ್, ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಆರಿಜಿನ್, ಅವಾಗಲೇ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡ್ತು ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಆರಿಜಿನ್ ವಿಮೆನ್ ದಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಔಟ್. ದೇ ಸೆಡ್ ದ ವೆರಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಡೇ ಕಮಲಾ ಹ್ಯಾರಿಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಡ್ ಗಾಯತ್ರಿ ಮಂತ್ರ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಅಂತ ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ವಿಚ್ ವಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್, ನೀವು ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು. ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ರೌಂಡ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಡಿಡ್ ಅ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಚೆಕ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಚೆಕ್ ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆರ್ ರಾಂಗ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಡಿಡ್ ದ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಚೆಕ್, ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ದಟ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ವಾಸ್ ರಿಯಲ್, ದ ಆಡಿಯೋ ವಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ರಿಯಲ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು ನಿಜಾನೇ, ಗಾಯತ್ರಿ ಮಂತ್ರ ಹಿಂದ್ಗಡೆ ಪ್ಲೇ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದು ನಿಜಾನೇ, ಬಟ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ವಾಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ವೇ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಇನ್ 2014. ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ 2020 ವೆನ್ ಶಿ ಟುಕ್ ಓವರ್ ದಿ ಆಫೀಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಇನ್ 2014. ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಮೇಯರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಅಮೆರಿಕನ್ ಮೇಯರ್ಶಿಪ್, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ಅವರು ಅವರ ಆಫೀಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಆಲ್ ಅಮೆರಿಕನ್ಸ್ ನ ನಿಲ್ಸಿ ಗಾಯತ್ರಿ ಮಂತ್ರ ವಾಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಡ್. ಬಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಆಫ್ 2014 ವಾಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ 2020 ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಕಮಲಾ ಹ್ಯಾರಿಸ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಟು ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಆರಿಜಿನ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ವಾಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಂಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದ ವೇ, ಯಾಕೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಹೇಳಕ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಡೂ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ವೈ ಆಮ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಡಿಡ್ ದ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಚೆಕ್, ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ವೆನ್ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ವಾಸ್ ಡನ್, ವೆನ್ ದ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್, ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಟೂಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್, ವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಈವನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದೋಸ್ ಟೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಯರ್ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವೆರಿಫೈ ವೆದರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಆಡಿಯೋ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ okay, so this is the last one. So again, the same thing. See, there may be some of the history teachers there, and it speaks about Lord Macaulay. He speaks about saying that I have not seen any country like India. Okay, education, that, this and all. And he say, I'm very, namu tumba punya India dalli uttidke adu idu anteno barthidare. But last all nodi, enanta barthidare. Share as much as possible. Whenever you people see the quote or a message saying that share as much as possible, let us let every Indian know how it feels, let every person knows on anganta andi takshne, please understand that it is completely a propaganda material. Okay, because only a person who wants to circulate it in a more number, only a person who wants to get more mileage of all these kind of a pictures or a video will ask you to share. Share as much as possible anta antakshane ankobeku, it is for their personal propaganda what they are doing. Okay, and I also doesn't know whether it is Lord Macaulay, because only history teacher can tell me whether it belongs, if the picture belongs to Lord Macaulay or not. How many of us have studied history? Okay, so these are some of the tricks, these are some of the ways in which the information on the social media is being misused and how we can brainwash. Yeah, we can take it up. That's the last slide. The next one. Yeah, you can go ahead. Okay, so this is what I wanted to say. So the main purpose of this particular module is to tell you that information what comes to you is not real. Even if the information is there, there are different kinds of information, like the misinformation, disinformation, and how the fake news can be created on the social media. You can end the slide, not a problem, you can end it. Okay, is there okay, and how these different kinds of the fake news are there? It can be images, it can be video, it can be audio, it can be propaganda, and how you can bifurcate those different kinds of fake news that has also been discussed. It has also been told to you with examples and with some case studies. And I know this is a very small time. 2 hours is a very longer period, I can understand. But it is very much necessary, because if you don't understand these things, in the future, things are going to be much, much more worse. Okay, and you know now, social media has taken over everybody's life. Okay, it has taken over all of our life, and it has started playing with the psychology also. Okay, so it is very much necessary for us to prepare the next generation, or at least to prepare the next civil society to be much aware on these kind of a things. Okay, this is what I wanted to say. Any observations, any questions, any discussions on this? We can take some 2 to 3 questions. Then I'll be able to, if the things are there, I'll be able to solve the clarifications which you people have. Anyways, thanks a lot. Ma'am, thank you. I'm on time, and I would
like to take it.
Thank you so much. Any questions or any observations, any additions you wanted to tell, you people are free to do that. Atanimmalli fake news, if you people have fallen prey for a fake news, or if you people have done the things deliberately, gottukottidu neevugalu maadirthira anta dina idre, if you want to share, you can tell me. Anything, please, because it has to be open up. Let us have some kind of interview, because I also want to know what you people feel, and what is that, or whether whatever we said is true or not, or whether you have any kind of suggestions can be given so that you can improvise. So that is also necessary. If there anything is there, you can always let me know that. Normally, the reason why we are going so much fast with social media is that we don't have a legal binding. Okay, there is nothing called as a legal thing in the country. Okay, nammalli constitutional rights illa nammalli. Ondu namge cyber law ide, cyber security ella ide. But when it comes to the posting of this Facebook matte social media anta bandaga, namme legal bindings illa. France is the only country which has got a strong legal regulations related to this, and US and UK also. US and UK to some extent, they also have some strict regulations. Nammalli enagutte yeah ma'am. Okay, nammalli enagogutte anta helidre, people are being fined, people are being taken, the account on sathi hack madidare antella hackers ge ondashtu fine aagtivi athwa salpa jail alli aagtivi aste, adu bitre there are no strict actions. So that is also one of the reason that people are not completely taking these things very seriously. Okay, people are getting scot free. Okay, even if you do a mistake, 3 thinglo jail ga aagtare, 4 thinglo jail ga aagtare, amdan puna free, puna bandmele puna ade kelsa madadu, hacking, propaganda, pseudo propaganda, ide tara kelsagalu madadu adalli. So the reason why we have started this kind of a campaigning or a kind of a sessions among all the people across the country is we want to make it as a law. Okay, we want to have a very strong, we want to open up the eyes of the government and tell that, see, social media is good for the society. It's informative, it stays connected. But in India, it is being used to break the country. Janagalna divide martta ide, culture na divide martta ide, gender na divide martta ide. So there has to be strong eye on that, which can have some legal, namalli legal binding illa andre tappage agutte. Okay, so ika Facebook alli nodirbodu, yesterday there was some thing going on in all the thing, 26th inda Facebook mate WhatsApp India dalli nintogutte anta bartha idu nodirbodu. Okay, so the thing is, the reason is Facebook nimge India dalli tumbha jaasti iradu, nam India dalli avarge the base of Facebook or the number of people who use TikTok India is the number one, now it is banned. Instagram has overtaken the other things. Okay, andre Instagram is one of them. India dalli Instagram use madidanga ellu use martta illa, Facebook use madidanga ellu use martta illa. So they have a very strong market in India, and majority of the people are youngsters. Okay, so these are also some of the reasons why social media has to be done. So I have a question from professor. I didn't get that question, ma'am. I was about to read, by then it went off. Can you just read it out for me, Dr. Pooja?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the question that is asked by one of our faculty member, your opinion about the establishment of news channels by the political parties in Karnataka state in India.
So thank you. That is completely out of the context, but anyways, yes, the one of the rule of the constitution, or one of the provision given by the constitution, is to One is freedom. Press is very free in India, and in a democratic country, you can't control the media, whether it is radio, TV, newspapers. So any individual who has got an intention and who has got the money and the human resources backing him are eligible to start a television channel. So that is the reason why political parties invest their money in these kind of channels, because they want to have a mouthpiece. Okay, they want somebody who can speak, who can blow their trumpet, avaru band baja avare badkolbekala, adukoskara they have that. But as I told, there has to be some restrictions. Okay, there should be a kind of a restrictions, but India is not a place where these kinds can be controlled. ನೀವು ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ರಷ್ಯಾ ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಐಮ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಮೋರಾ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಟರಿ ಅಥಾರಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಮೋರಾ MORA ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ರಷ್ಯಾ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ರಷ್ಯಾ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಇದೆ ಫಾರ್ ಓನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಯು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಎ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಷಿಯನ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಎನಿ ಪಾರ್ಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ವರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಯುವರ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಾರಿ ಯುವರ್ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ದಿಸ್ ಯು ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ದಟ್ ಅಂತ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಅಥಾರಿಟಿ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಅಥಾರಿಟೀಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲವಲ್ಲ. We don't have anything. Any person with a intention to start and you have a money, you can do that. So that is also one of the bad thing why news channels have gone to dogs, is because there is no ethics. People do it only for money, only for advertisements, and only for their own propaganda. If you go to Kasturi channel, you'll see only issues, regulations of JDS. If you go to one particular one NDTV, you'll see only Congress. If you go to NDT, if you go to the other channels, it is only about BJP. Okay, so they, every party are, and even the media are also associated with it. Okay, so you can't separate media with the political party. Only thing is, there has to be some strict rules, and people have to be more, what you call, educated, and people should question. Until and unless people don't question the very working nature of the media, media will never wake up. They are just, earlier we used to call media as watchdogs. Okay, kavalu naigalu avaru ella, because they are one of the important thing for democracy. But today all media have become lap dogs. Lap, okay, they sit on the lap of the politicians, they sit on the lap of the corporates, because they are the people who are funding them. So when you are funding them, so you obviously have to become a mouthpiece. So these are the situations. So we here, the question is not about that, but as you raise the question, I'm telling you that media today has gone for dogs, and although 90% of the media in India is controlled by politicians or corporates, and they are completely within that framework. They work according to the framework given by the government and given by the politicians, and they don't have press for freedom, seriously. So majority of them use the social media to air their opinions, and they are curbed. 10% jana papa maatadbeku anta social media dal band maatadtare, and you label them as anti-nationals, you label them as a terrorist, you label them as a this, that, and all. So the voice is snubbed. So this is what is happening. You start trolling the people, you start creating the memes, you start killing the people who raise their voice. So ultimately we are also becoming a kind of a dictatorship. We are, because when the government said you can't post anything on social media about the Indian government, it is curbing our right. It is our right to post anything. I have all the right to write about the government if I find something wrong. When I went to the vaccination, I paid the money, I got my vaccination done. When I came back, I wrote it on my Facebook and I said, this is not going to happen. I pay my income tax. Why should a person pay for a vaccination? I had money, I am a salaried person, I can pay. But just imagine the plight of a farmer. How can he pay 1,200 rupees for a particular thing? So I have to write in a way that which can convey my message to the thing. So for that thing, social media is good. So you can use it for a constructive purpose. The main purpose of this kind of a workshop is to sensitize our people, sensitize people like you, sensitize our academic friends, my colleagues, and all, so that you will also become a thinker. So I use that particular place not for submissive propaganda or not for religious propaganda, but for the development of the society. If 10 people write, 100 people start writing, we'll start a campaign. We can start a campaign in the country. So that is how, see, ivat aagid takshana nale aagibidute janagalu, they'll stop spreading fake news. Illa, at least for 4 years, at least in a time of 5 years, things can be changed. So that is the reason why we have started these kind of a campaigning from past last year. It's been more than 14-15 months since these kind of activities, workshops. We have been able to train take class for more than 25,000 people all over the country. We have been able to train them. I don't say all 25,000 will work, but at least on 2,000-3,000 janakar on the idea irutte. So next time aadade hogde irabodu. Okay, so this is what sensitizing the people in a smaller way. So that is what our intention is all about. So hopefully I've answered your question. But as I told, media can't be regulated. They have to be regularized. Government madak agala because ours is a democratic country. Tappu kuda agutte. But media nu kuda, they should be socially responsible. We work for social responsibility, but majority of them have forgotten they are working for social responsibility. They are working for politicians and corporates and the people who fund them. So that's a wrong state of affair what we have. It's an open secret. Everybody knows, everybody criticizes. That's the thing, sir. Yeah. Anything else, Pooja? Any other things?
No, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Thank you, Soumya. And I also thank the principal, Dr. Soumya Irappa, for giving me this opportunity. Extremely sorry for keeping you people more waited, because I know I'm already 1 hour late because of technical thing. But I'm very grateful that you people could listen and you people have interacted and take away something which is very important for you in the class tomorrow. I thank you once again, Dr. Soumya.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for this information session. I request Pooja ma'am to render out of thanks.
Ma'am, before the thing, there is a called feedback form, which I'll be sharing to you, the feedback form. So those ever who have participated have to give a feedback form. It is up to them. They can give the feedback that there is nothing wrong. I'll share that thing with Soumya ma'am and she'll post it in the group. Please fill it up and send it across, ma'am.
We'll do it, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Hello? Hello?
Yeah, you're listening.
Hello, ma'am. I have an observation. My name is Sushma. Ma'am, as you said, no media is unbiased these days. Yeah. And very recently, we saw the heart-wrenching pictures of the funeral pyres, you know, burning during the second wave of the COVID, right?
Yeah.
It was very much circulated in both the national and the international media.
Yes,
you
yes.
know, it was posted in the front page of the so-called big newspapers called as
mainly.
Yeah, New York Times, Washington Post, ABC News, even the British Broadcasting Corporation, which is the BBC. And if you see, the same things of the funeral or whatever, of their countries has not been posted in the main page like that. Okay, but they do that in our country. And it sort of creates, you know, the mass hysteria in people. And also another thing is that when they quote this fatality rate, no, in other countries, they do it per million. That means per lakh. Yes. 10 crores. Yes. So, other than Nam country quote, they quote absolute numbers. You know, it's
Ma'am,
sort of maligned
what...
India's image, you know, globally.
Yes.
And
yes,
this
yes.
is also a sort of propaganda, you know.
Yeah, that's the problem. That's what I'm telling you, that is how the media works. Because for a Western country, India is a growing economy. Please understand, even now, that is the discussion what is happening at the international political circle is, when all the other countries have gone back to normalcy, why only Brazil, why only India is suffering? Because they are the growing economy. And the main purpose of these Western media is to show these two countries in a bad light so that the economy in the world market goes down automatically. It is not only about the COVID. It's not, I know the people are suffering. We are also suffering. At the same time, we have lost the life. But the only thing is, you should also understand the other phase of this economy wherein they want to bring down the image of these developed, Brazil is there, Russia is there.
Yeah, yeah.
India, aste country ne suffer martu ivaglu kuda ni just look into the paper, only these five countries are suffering. The others are okay. Even South Africa is okay, but Brazil is suffering like India is there. China is being already outside the market of the world, and even the Russia. So it's to betray, and then there are, as I told, unseen people, there are unseen hands who are working behind all these things. That is completely a political game. And as you told, they will not highlight their country's plight, because USA, there was a ban. In US, there was a restrictions of showing dead bodies, burning the dead bodies. The government has issued the orders for all the people not to show. But nammal maadilvala. Nammal maadidanale, we say that is our right. You want to show the reality. So this is the main problem. That's the reason why I'm telling you that there has to be some common rules, regulations about media ethics. Because as you told, yellaru namthara stronger girala. Even seeing the dead bodies, many of the people have got heart attack. Okay, so the thing is, you need to play with the media plays with the psychology of the people also. You have to be a little bit cautious. That is there. Then they know the self-reliant market. We have to do a self-assessment. ನಾವು ರೆಟ್ರೋಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು, ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಟ್ರೂ, ತೋರಿಸ್ಬೇಕಾ ತೋರಿಸ್ಬೇಡವಾ ಅಂತ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಇದು ಬರಬೇಕು, ಮೀಡಿಯಾದವ್ರಿಗೆ ಬರಬೇಕು. ಅದು ಮೀಡಿಯಾದವ್ರಿಗೆ ಬರಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್
They are totally unbiased, true. And also one more thing, ma'am, I very respectfully, you know, slightly disagree with what you said. You said that Kumbh Mela is a super spreader. And I just got into the numbers, you know, of the Kumbh and the timeline. You know, that Kumbh happened in January 21 and in February, you know, the early part of February. And already, yeah, 21, yeah. And, you know, the if you see the COVID boom, it was actually based in, you know, Delhi, Maharashtra and also Kerala. And around that time, you know, it was already in lakhs. The number were already in lakhs. And if you see the positive numbers in Kumbh Mela, you see, it is around 1,000 or 1,500. And there was no mass migration of people from Kerala to these countries. I mean, these states. So, we cannot call it, you know, super spreader. Because we do not have a proper scientific evidence to say that there was migration and that is why the COVID boom happened in these, you know, states. Because there were already in lakhs around that time. And also, maybe the political rallies were a thing.
But elections
were a thing. But if you see, the COVID boom is not much as in the other states as compared to the, you know, the states which went for elections.
For
example, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Kerala or whatever. The COVID boom, you can see basically in Delhi, the population is nothing in Delhi when compared to UP. There was no boom in UP, but it was in Delhi and also in Maharashtra. So that is what is my observation is.
Did you observe? Okay, fine. Whatever you said, I accept it, Sushma. But at the same time, did you one more thing? What one more theory says is Delhi mein you don't have a BJP government. Maharashtra mein you don't have a BJP government. Kerala we don't have a BJP government except the state of Karnataka. There is also one more theory which says that they are intentionally targeting the thing because I've seen deaths even in Gujarat also. But you know that the Gujarat deaths are already been covered up. Okay, deaths in Gujarat, as no torstala namge. When I speak to my friend, they tell me that.
Because the media is not very much interested in Gujarat or Chhattisgarh or something else. You know,
because the government will not allow that. That's what I'm telling. This is what you call as conspiracy theories and propaganda theories, where you want to highlight. You know, Delhi source is there, Arvind Kejriwal government there. You know, Rajasthan like source there, Rajasthan like BJP government there. Not show you. That's what I'm telling you. As people, see, you're a thinker. You think, you read, you have the data with you. So you, when you do this, the second unit, the first unit, but information. Secondly, we have something called the critical thinking. So whatever you told me that we speak in the second module, where we tell people how we are supposed to do the critical thinking. There are 61 kinds of critical thinking you can do that. 61 ತರ ಇದೆ ಕ್ರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಆಯ್ತಾ. ಯಾವ ಯಾವ ತರ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಯಾವ ಯಾವ ತರ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಗೆ ಬೇರೆ, ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಸಿ ದ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಶಾಪ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಥಿಂಕ್. ಯು ಸಿ ಯು ಆರ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ನೌ ವೈ ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್, ಯಾಕೆ ಮೀಡಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ವೈ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಹೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ರೀಸನ್ಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡನ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ಫುಲಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. Okay, so I'm very happy that at least some kind of food for thought has gone into you and some kind of a thinking. Maybe you will think 100 times tomorrow. Maybe your thinking might have gone into another 40, 50 people of our group today. So this is the main purpose. So the main idea here is to make people think at the same time, see what the reality is all about. Rather than accepting whatever comes on the Facebook or social media or the newspaper, we have to think and come up with some solutions. Yeah.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, Sushma. Thank you. So, ma'am, can you wind up? Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, Pooja is ready.
Yeah. Okay.
So, good afternoon, one and all. I would like to render oath of thanks for today's FDP session. Firstly, I would like to thank our guest speaker, Dr. Sapna, for addressing and enlightening us with her knowledge. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Today's FTP session was full of interesting things. I would like to thank each and everyone for your presence. I thank everyone.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Yeah, you too. Have a nice day. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.